As far as my life goes,
yeah.
Everything else is shit.
Oh, I didn't even go live yet. Everyone missed here.
Oh, well, there you
go. Whole rant about how shitty 2022 is. Well, and how this show is the only thing that kept you from killing yourself.
I didn't say that specifically, but this is the one bright spot in an otherwise shitty
year. But you didn't disagree with it.
My suicidal tendencies can go unstated. No, I don't have
a band.
Yeah, that is a band. I get suicide, you know, I get it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We all get it.
I wish someday I'll tell you, whatever.
What? Is this another bummer episode while I have
fireworks on my side?
Yeah,
I was
going to
say.
All sad.
Can people, is this going to be distracting for the show if Dick the entire time has.
What's distracting about
explosions going on behind him?
There's nothing to see here. Please move along. There's nothing to see here, right? Naked Gun.
See, this is it's unfair that you have a cool green screen and get your own custom background. I am stuck with a poster of you and a T-shirt of you.
That's cool stuff, though.
Yeah. As I suggested, I wanted to, you know, spice up my side. Yeah. I feel like I should have some stuff on my side.
Okay.
So I got something that I'm going to hang up.
Move that mic a little bit before you do it.
Okay.
I need to focus on you.
I wanted to show solidarity for the people of Ukraine, of course. So we'll just hang this up, I'm sure. Is that the right way?
Yeah, that's the right way. It's yellow on top.
Yeah.
Yellow on the bottom would be like piss.
That can go.
Okay.
I'll figure that out later.
You can't. Now you gotta burn it. You drop the flag.
That's
you have to burn it now.
Pretty sure. I have to get it signed by a bunch of Ukrainian soldier guys, you know, like they did in Congress. Wasn't that?
Oh.
Were you inspired by that?
By the yearbook signing of the Ukrainian flag?
Yeah.
That was a bunch of soldiers?
I don't know who signed it. Here, I'll just tuck it in.
Tuck it in. Get it right.
Just like,
Vito, that's very...
There we go.
It's very insulting the way you've done it.
I can't even
see it. Why don't you put it on something? Staple it to something.
This bit is less funny than I thought it would be.
Oh, you gotta do it right.
Well,
you got a safety pin in or something.
There's a safety pin.
Okay, you got one. Safety pin it to something. You're doing a half-assed job. That's why it's not funny.
Let's get it together for...
Yeah. See, now it's funny because you're taking a bunch of time. I don't know if that's in frame.
Well,
do you have another safety pin or did you just get the one?
Found one.
Okay, so you found one and you took it 4 feet off the camera to put it up?
I assume I'll find a second one. The flag is big.
I'm looking at one right there. I really hate that you're doing this in here. Because the rules are that I can't take it down.
Wait, is that really the rule?
Well, I mean, that's like the rules of, you know, having fun and screwing around. You can't just take something down because you don't like it.
There's one thing. I've got a pin here.
That's great. I've got a...
And I've put it... Okay, wait. There we go.
It's hanging it up. There's a safety pin right there on the shirt. Did you get that?
I got that.
Here, I'm gonna play some music while you hang up the Ukrainian flag in the studio. whenever it loads, whenever it chooses to load for me. What?
That was the wrong anthem.
What are you talking about?
Play the anthem of my Ukrainian brothers.
I don't know why this browser is going all fucking slow. It's all janky.
This is my tribute to the people of Ukraine. Down with Russia. Down with Putin. And glory to our brothers in the Ukrainian, all of them. Except for that one battalion. Those guys, no good.
Are we sending enough money to the Ukraine?
Not nearly enough.
Not enough
missiles for Ukraine.
How much more?
Every Ukrainian child should have a Patriot missile system.
Rank these in order of importance.
Every single Ukrainian.
Black reparations, war in Ukraine, Israel.
Israel's the top, but... Other than that, America does right by our allies. God bless some
Who are our allies
Ukraine.
In Ukraine.
God bless.
In what way
Zelensky.
Are they our allies?
You know, because they're fighting the Ruskies, man. They're fighting the Reds.
Why does that make them our allies?
Because Russia sucks, man. We're going to take them down.
Why does Russia suck?
Because they're invading people for no reason. They can't just do that.
No, they're protecting those territories that voted for their independence.
No.
It would be like if Texas declared its independence and then the U.S. invaded and then Japan nuked the U.S.
Just invade countries. All right. Will you stop playing fucking the Russian national anthem?
Okay. Jeez.
Play some Ukrainian music.
I have to close this window first. It's going too slow.
Play, what's Zelensky dancing and singing? I love that guy.
I'm a dancer for money. Is that
what the song he did?
Yeah.
What a great man. What a great country. And,
He's not great.
I think we here at the show, we just support the Ukraine and the Ukrainian people. At least one of us does.
No. I don't. Okay, let me make sure everything's going here. You ready to start the show?
Yes.
I think you're pretty obviously ready. Here we go.
Yeah.
Everything is going. Hold on. I'm gonna restart and reset. Everything's messed up. Actually, it might be my fireworks. Let's see if that's.
Yeah, I wonder if that's like.
Yeah, it was my fireworks.
Okay. All right. You go. Busy background.
Fuck that.
Biggest problem in the universe.
Fuck this. Welcome to the biggest problem in the universe. The only show that ranks every problem in the universe from hateful crosswords to entitled movie nerds. What do you think about that one?
N-words or something.
Title. Zelensky, are you talking about? I'm your host, Dick Masterson. Joining me as always is Vito Giswaldi.
Hi, Dick.
What's up, buddy? Thanks for ruining my studio.
I've ruined your studio. I showed up late. I'm a mess.
I also have to tell you something.
Yeah.
It's upside down.
Fuck. Are you sure? Damn it. Wait. It is upside down. They'll get the message regardless. They know. Isn't that a sign of distress? That means I've gravely insulted.
When I said that's the right way, didn't you suspect
you're giving me?
Yeah.
God damn it.
Well, we want to redo it. We got 10 minutes.
Yeah. You
know,
no.
I can put the Russian national anthem back on if you want to redo it.
Please don't.
Okay. It's New Year.
We'll fix it later, maybe.
New Year, new bonus episode.
Yes, we will be doing. When are we going to post it? The first.
Yeah, we can post it to first.
We'll try
What's
to.
Today?
The
yeah,
biggest problem in 2022, we're going to do a recap of the year's biggest problems.
What do you think the biggest problem in 2020?
Well, don't people have to listen to the show? Oh, in 2023?
We should have done some predictions.
Oh, that's going
right?
to be
We can do that next week.
The world war that this evil Putin ushers in. We'll take care of him.
I don't know if you're joking or not. That's the problem.
I think it's shitty that what Russia did, and I think it's funny that everybody's so mad that we're like doing the obvious American thing of throwing money at, you know, foreign militaries. Like it's something we've never done before. It's like, guys,
get it.
We're America. Like, what did you think was ever going to happen? I can't believe we're spending so much money on a foreign war.
Yeah.
Well, you live in America. Like, just get used to it. That's all we ever do.
Okay.
It's not going to stop. You complaining about it isn't going to change it.
Why don't we get into the war game? It's our sell podcast to. We could go do the USO tour.
Honestly,
not for free though.
You know what? We should be marketing to the military boys overseas.
Okay, are you ready for the?
Yeah.
We don't have any bullshit to go over this week, do we? Any kind of beefs or anything?
I had a couple little things that I was.
Would you have a
briefly mention?
Would you have a? Okay.
Vito's Twitter.
Not necessarily Twitter related.
Vito's Twitter.
Okay, what's your beef then?
Melanie Mack has a stalker, and I think this is part of Satan's continued campaign to punish her for not coming on the show.
Okay.
She put out a
stalker you?
No, apparently. Oh. But she made a YouTube video about how some strange older man has been stalking her and trying to come to her house, and I think that's an agent of Satan, and he's telling her. Should have just come
on
biggest
the show.
Problem. Yeah. And
we're
going to
send more, Melanie.
We're going to send more.
We're communicating with the Dark Lord right now.
I'm telling him
to send creepier stalkers.
I also, oh my God. Yeah, I was going to say, this is the other thing.
Did you happen to see this?
I was made aware that
Super killer fan comic? What? Isn't that amazing?
He's got more pages done than the actual comic. That's not
your
true.
Your comic's not even out, and someone has done
someone
a super
is
killer
a fan, comic.
Fan comic where super killer kills.
Well, he's not killing them, unfortunately.
Sailor Moon. She's a superhero, right? So he rapes her.
Does he? I don't think he kills her, though.
She happened to get raped in the process. Is yeah. that on brand for you? I know you weren't a fan of the.
He's like
I saw him one for some reason.
This one, the one where he, yeah, the fact that there is now a super killer rapist parody comic. Again,
it's hentai and it's art.
I would like to express that this is not going to be a good look for my plan to have legitimate publishing success with the character.
He kills superheroes.
Before the first comic even comes out, it's like, oh, yeah, I've seen this. That's the one where he rapes teenage anime girls, right?
Sailor Moon, though.
Yeah, well, it's
okay
Sailor Moon.
In this universe that they're in. The age of consent is
yeah,
like
I don't know how
12.
Old this magical girl is that he's supposedly having sex with. The first panel, do you want to show it?
I don't know if I can show it.
Well, did he show? I think he'd show the first page.
Let me see. Let me see if I can show it. It's just me and Sean here. All right. Here we go.
Okay. His name's Super Something-er.
I don't know why he bleeped that out.
Yeah, I don't know why he thought that could make it in.
I do superheroes. I do superheroes.
Well, I guess it's leaving it up to the imagination.
If it's raper or
yeah,
not.
Yeah, is he raper? Is he fucker? But he says he's going to blank the shit out of this anime girl.
She could be 18. I don't
Guys,
know.
This is terrible. What are you... Why are you...
Well, he kills superheroes.
He doesn't have sex with them first. He doesn't molest
Why not?
Schoolgirls. Because what does that help? What does that do for the greater good?
What does killing them have to do with the greater good?
That has
are you
whole...
saying he wouldn't? If he got the order to rape Sailor Moon, he would just not do it and let all the universes be destroyed?
I'm not going to spoil... The comic, you'll have to read it. But no, he would not rape Sailor Moon.
I would.
His character.
If it meant saving the universe and I could put a couple bucks in my pocket,
yeah,
I'd do anything.
Okay. Well...
What, are you going to read it? And I'm going to rape the shit out of this one.
Well, we don't know if he's going to... I don't know what he's going to do, because it's in fucking whatevers. And then Sailor Moon... This is pretty well done. Has to go stop a fire... And then in the next page, real quick, if we can scroll down.
She transforms. She goes, it must be a fire. While no one is looking, I'm going to transform into Sailor Moon. Hi-ya!
Yeah. Okay. And then encounters my character with a bundle of rope.
Yeah. His super killer brand ropes. For binding.
Now, this guy also sent me an email. He said, these are the safe pages.
Oh, there's more to this titillating tale?
There's more.
Ooh.
There's pages that are not yet done, but he is going to apparently go the full. Yeah, well, there. This is afterwards. Why did he give him a 5 o'clock shadow? Like he's a.
Yeah, he's been raping for a long time.
Well, at least she looks satisfied, but did he kill her after? Jesus Christ, this is horrible.
Yeah, of course he killed her. She'll probably
nightmare.
Kill herself because she's so addicted to cock.
Anyway,
now.
I'm very appreciative of all the fan enthusiasm.
Yeah.
I just feel like people aren't getting the gist of the character. I feel like they've come up with some headcanon to who he is and what he's about.
He's about raping.
Maybe going down. Yeah. These fan theories about him being a... neck kneeling rapist are maybe a little off base in terms of what we're trying to accomplish with the character.
Which one did you like more? The raping one or the killing George Floyd, the kneeling on Isom one?
I think
which was your favorite?
Do I really have to, I'm not gonna call
which one did you like?
I'm not gonna call
which,
either
which
of
one
them
did you
favorite.
Like less? Which one did you think was worse?
I still think the Isom one is
so you like the raping one more
no,
than
I mean the rape is bad.
Is it because she's
well she looked like she enjoyed it. She looked like she had a good time.
That's
if she didn't enjoy
say.
It, that would be different. But he's like, hey, so maybe they can. And there's missing pages. Maybe they worked out a consensual situation, you know?
Is it really? Can it be consensual after that brandishing of the rope, though? Like, I don't think you can have consent
if he says,
after
hey,
that.
Can I tie you up? It might be fun. And then she
I'm
going
to do it anyway.
Well, then that's not consensual. Yeah, this is a nightmare. What is wrong with you people? It's just...
So would you like everyone to keep going or stop?
Oh, my God. Do whatever you want. I don't care anymore. This is a nightmare. It's gonna be like indie comic sensation Vito with his rapey black murdering superhero takes the nation by storm.
The ultimate anti-hero.
To jump off a bridge. Something's wrong with all you fucking people.
I didn't think they could top the I saw one.
They're really fighting to see who can offend me the most.
But then I loaded it up and I was like, oh, I saw
well,
that.
He made a whole comic. He's got like multiple pages. It's like a whole thing. Jesus Christ.
What about Crypto, the super dog?
What, should he rape the dog
or kill it or whatever? Yeah.
If you want to show super killer killing and raping a dog, I can tell you my reaction will not be positive. I can assure you of that.
You're first, folks.
You heard it here first. Super killer is not canonically a dog rapist.
Okay.
All right.
Did you have any more Twitter stuff?
No, I have no other Twitter stuff.
Okay.
Then let's do the problem winners. Last week.
The omnibus spending bill.
Boring.
Okay. Swastika scaries.
Swastika scaries was a great problem.
Going to the dentist.
Yeah.
And then maybe the worst problem ever brought in, the most unaware, the most self-unaware problem we've ever had on the show, fan entitlement.
Yeah.
The
You're
most
right.
oblivious to...
Tim Burton shouldn't be allowed to direct Batman because we, the fans, know better. The point is... Maybe it's
you
a
made
fan,
that joke last
maybe
time.
Instead of fan entitlement, it's like fans believing they possess this mystical wisdom.
Yeah.
I'm like, if I asked you to write a Batman story, it would be 99 out of 100 times.
Me, personally?
Just any Batman fan would write a bad Batman story.
Okay.
Sometimes you got to trust the process.
How's that process working out so far at Disney?
Well, I don't know. It's a mess, but...
It's bad.
I thought that most recent Batman movie was pretty good.
Which one was that?
The one with Robert Pattinson.
I couldn't finish it.
It was a little convoluted.
It was just so... And then the ocean was attacking Gotham. Yeah. I was like, what is it, Mr. Ocean?
You know what,
on second thought,
I don't know. It had some... It looked good. The guy's a good cinematographer. I just thought the plot kind of sucks.
Yeah.
But I loved how that movie looked.
And the penguin's supposed to go like, wah, wah, wah.
Well, it's a different interpretation.
Not like, oi, Batman.
On the penguin day, Batman.
I'm.
You know, there was who played the penguin? It was like...
Danny DeVito?
No, some Farrell. It's Colin Farrell in the new one.
What? That's that had his wiener out?
Yeah, the big fat, he got big and... Or I don't know if they did a bunch of makeup or whatever. But they were supposed to make a whole penguin TV show. Like, he got, like, so into it. And you're like, I don't want to watch a penguin TV show.
Sucks, actually.
Yeah.
I wanted to hear one, not even when he died, if he did die. I didn't know. I didn't.
Well, do you like the Tim Burton? You like Danny DeVito as the penguin where he literally is like part penguin and his like hands are like.
Yeah, that was great.
That's a little
honestly.
Much. That's a little much.
I saw that in the theaters. I was like, oh, shit.
And he's
there
like,
he what,
wasn't he like eating raw fish?
Yeah.
Yeah, see, the penguin was originally just like our aristocrat who was called the penguin because he's squat and fat.
But he looked like he had to go, wow.
Making
wah,
him
wah.
Into an actual part penguin man, mutant, was a little much, Tim Burton.
Okay. So you think the big duck going down the street was a bit much, too? The giant duck rope?
I appreciate Tim Burton's brain. It's fun.
Okay. Corrosive Drew said... The Carl bit had me in tears. He even did the smile talking.
Has Carl said anything about this bit?
I think he said it, he loved it.
I have to re-upload it as a clip on the channel. I've been uploading clips.
Yeah, you do. My Room Records says, hey, Vito, the greatest book adaptation of all time was made because an entitled superfan worked for over a decade to make it happen and spent a colossal amount of time ensuring it was as close to the book as possible for a cinema adaptation, Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, but that's different. I'm not saying that one individual fan can't be, like, really good at a thing. It's the whole concept of the fans. As a massive group who, like, their collective willpower can make great creative decisions.
I see. Okay.
It's not how it works.
Mm. What do you think of that Henry Cavill thing that he's, like...
Making a Warhammer? Or that he got
no,
fired?
He was like being awesome on the set of The Witcher.
Yeah.
Not letting those dumb broads ruin the show.
It is an interesting article.
You know they would have Me Too'd him if he, if like anyone would have been like, yeah, right. Right? Like if he was just ugly.
Yeah, if he was ugly, they would have Me Too'd him, but instead they have to call him toxic.
He's addicted to video games, actually. Oh. Like, okay, I believe you.
I'm excited to see what he does. He's making a Warhammer universe. We'll see how that goes.
Dexter says, when Super Killer gets fans, read The Day After Never.
Wow. Nailed it. Really got me.
Right. It's nice. It's nice to know they'll be respected.
You're respected insofar as I respect you for being
buying
a fan,
my stuff.
But if you came to me and you said, well, I've read every issue of Super Killer and I don't think he would do that.
I have.
I think he would rape this girl.
That was
that's
the only
when I go,
issue of Super Killer that exists.
See, this is why the fans are wrong. Because the fans go, Super Killer loves kneeling on people's necks and raping anime women. And I go, see, you as the fans, I appreciate your enthusiasm, but you have to understand that you do not have the understanding of this creative universe like the creators themselves.
Crapping on every content creator on Twitter is also a great way to generate hype for your product. Thumbs up emoji.
The point is, if you're a fan, like the best kind of fan is the one who goes, I can't wait to see what they come up with next.
Well, I think that it should be like, I mean, I'm not saying that the creators can't make mistakes, but
it's a lot of this, like, I could have done it better.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have done that. And it's like, well, yeah, but you're never going to be in a position to make that movie, and you don't know how to make a movie, so just shut the fuck up.
But then you also criticize people who are creating things.
Yeah.
Like,
I hate everything.
I saw them and Doug Tenapel.
Yeah. No, I support I support Eric's right to make that comic.
You just... No, that's the one problem you have with it.
No. If Eric had just said, I'm making a comic, I don't know if it's going to be good, I don't know if it's going to be bad, but I'm excited to make it, and I hope people check it out.
Okay.
Like, yeah, that's the right attitude to take.
That's what he said until it was like $2
million. No. Right out the bat, he said, the comic book industry hates you, and they hate your children, and they're going to turn your kids gay, and the only way to stop it is to buy my comic book.
Oh.
And that's what I took issue with.
Okay.
If it was just a guy and he's like, you know, I've never written a comic before, but I want to give it a try. I'm enthusiastic about comics. I'd be like, yeah, go nuts. Yeah. It's this whole, like, I've never done this before in my life and I'm going to revolutionize the industry that I go, well, that sounds ridiculous to me.
Okay. Well, maybe that guy will give you a thumbs down, I guess, sarcastically. Yeah. Mr. Painkiller says, why not just give the fan? Oh, this is more fan stuff.
I'm glad I pissed off everybody.
Dogmatic Socrates says, you can buy the plaque removal equipment on Amazon.
You know what? I actually saw that comment and I looked it up.
Can you? It's easy. Just be careful and go slow, but you can do it yourself. I'm not going slow on plaque removal.
It's like $45. I thought about buying it. I don't know.
This guy, Riverbeard, says, no, Vito. The white part of the crosswords was the swastika. So you were reading it wrong. That's why you didn't see a swastika.
No,
you were imagining it in the wrong place.
No, I understand where they thought they saw a swastika. It's still really...
It was the white part.
If it's a swastika... Excuse me.
Yeah.
Oh. Sorry, I was about to sneeze. If it's a swastika, it's a very fat, terrible swastika.
Yeah, I agree. Bone says, I hope your teeth aren't bleeding this week, Dick. I hope they're not bleeding.
Yeah, was that because you needed to go to the dentist?
I do. I've needed to go forever, but I can't get my fucking girlfriend to
find
me a dentist
my health insurance
and
card. And then I call them and they go, we're out of town for the fucking holidays. I go, I'm never going to get to see this doctor.
Me either. I'm just going to pull him out.
Dick, I have an exciting segment.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Wait, let me cue up the music.
Now, hold on. I got to say, I know this stinger is a little longer than some of the other ones, but.
Okay.
I hope you'll bear with me.
All right. Well, you put a lot of work into it, so I'm in.
This is my masterpiece.
There lived a certain man in L.A. long ago.
He was bald and Armenian and had a podcast show.
He talked big game. He loved to brag and boast.
But he still got cucked by his Mexican co-host.
Wow.
Tried to sue for $20 million. Thought that he was quite the shark. Now he streams on Twitch as a banana, and Dick owns his trademark. So vote it up. Don't be like that stupid
that's good.
Crying alone on bed sheets of slime. Vote it up with a little bit of luck. Dick won't cuck his co-host.
host a second time.
Please don't cock me, Dick.
Vote it up, folks.
Okay.
Seems like you had an epiphany during that one.
Yeah, because I've just remembered the Boogie's video that he posted.
Oh, yeah. I should have brought that up. Oh,
fuck, I can't find it. If anybody has it, post it in the...
I'm sure it was on Twitter. I know you've been fighting with Boogie2988. Well, this is Voted Up, the part where we revisit past problems. In episode 9, Dick, hospital pricing transparency noncompliance. That was one of yours.
Yeah.
Well, one of our fans, Innocent Bystander, commented on this problem, says, I went to the ER a few months ago. They just prescribed me some shit, and were like, you could take all these other tests, but it's probably this, so just take this prescription. Okay, I go to leave, and they say that's how much you owe. I say, I'll pay that amount now. And now I'm getting calls from collection places saying I owe a bunch of extra money because I only paid the hospital and not the doctor.
Yeah.
what is with our healthcare system? This is ridiculous.
It goes right to collections.
Yeah.
They didn't even let you.
They just send it immediately to collections when they're like, you owe us a couple bucks.
I think so. Yeah.
And you don't even know what you owe. You don't even know what fucking happened.
Neither do they.
Yeah. I will say, I think we've mentioned it on the show before, but I always see this tip where if you go to the doctor and they go like, hey, it's $1,800, go, I need an itemized receipt of like every procedure.
They'll say, never mind. It's free.
No, honestly,
just get out of here.
Honestly, like they'll like go, oh, we itemized it out and it's like $1,000. It's
yeah.
like less.
Yeah.
So keep an eye out for that because they always try
too.
To. Yeah, it's weird. It's like they just make up numbers. It's crazy. Anyway, that was hospital pricing transparency not compliance, which is currently number 9 on our list.
Good.
Dick. Top Good. 10 problem from you. But you know what your most popular problem is, Dick?
What?
All the way back in episode 2, fat brain. Well, to back you up, Dick, a new yeah. study shows that ultra-processed foods are linked to cognitive decline and dementia.
Dementia, wow.
A study followed more than 10,000 Brazilians, and those who consumed the most ultra-processed foods had a 28% faster rate of cognitive decline and a 25% faster rate of executive function decline
wow.
compared to those who ate less than 20%.
Take that, you fat
so
bodies.
So if you're eating foods such as frozen pizzas, hot dogs, sausages, sodas, cookies, cakes, candies, donuts, and ice cream,
yeah.
You may experience a faster decline in your mental...
Fat brain.
Yeah, fat brain.
Literally fat brain.
That is currently problem number 3, Dick.
Yeah, I didn't mean it like that, though. I mostly just meant, like, fat chicks posting on Instagram and looking at how hot they are.
Well, it can have multiple
like that.
Meanings. That's the fun of the problems.
I don't know. I meant it
maybe
more in
they
that
have,
way.
But maybe they're posting that shit because they have a cognitive decline from eating all
maybe.
These ultra-processed foods.
Maybe.
I don't know why I'm trying to help you. You know what? You're right. Vote it down. Vote it down is the segment. Anyway, Dick, vote it up. Don't forget to go to biggestproblem.show. Vote on all the problems.
Okay.
And help your friends out. Did you find a
No, I'll do it
that
another
is
time.
A man
you can play the whole thing.
LA
yeah, of course.
Ago.
I have
he
to.
He was bald and
That's the rule.
And had a podcast show.
He talked big game. He loved to brag and boast.
But he still got cut
Speaking
by his Mexican
of
co-host.
Boasting.
Tried to sue
yes.
for $20 million. Thought that he was quite the shark. Now he streams on Twitch as a banana and Dick owns his trademark. So vote, vote, vote it up. Don't be like that stupid cunt. Crying alone on red sheets of slime. Vote, vote, vote it up. With a little bit of luck, Dick will cuck his co-host a second time.
Please don't cuck me, Dick.
It did work pretty well.
Good one.
Boom.
Dance to that for New Year's. Vito, have you heard?
Oh, God.
Have you heard about The Matrix?
Jesus Christ. Yeah. Yeah, I've heard about it.
Do you
it.
Think that's a real microphone you're speaking into?
Oh, my God.
The Matrix
my
is
God.
All around us, Vito.
Yeah.
The Matrix, you know. You
Why have Matrix metaphors? Why is that the big thing? It's always red pills and rabbit holes and... Mr. Anderson, it's like these guys only saw, you know how they always say, like, why do you keep comparing everything to Harry Potter? Women. Why do men keep comparing everything to the fucking
Matrix?
Your favorite
phrase is the fucking red pill. You use it in a sentence. The red, pill this, red pill that. You're criticizing fucking Harry Potter
You're
and Drag Queens.
You're not allowed to criticize people who go like, this is just like when Thanos or whatever.
You
the
have
You're
no
doing
vocabulary
that.
Without the Matrix. You have no ideas without the Matrix. You can't express yourself to your contemporaries without one movie.
It's Stop! Really, yeah, it's really bad.
Andrew Tate did a little whoopsie doopsie this week.
What a whoopsie. What a, I feel like he sabotaged his brand overnight.
I think it's the worst thing I've ever seen. And yeah. it cannot be forgiven.
It can't be undone.
It cannot be defended.
Yeah.
Andrew Tate's 2-minute nonsensical screed was the on how he has small dick energy.
Yeah.
Was the worst, most painful 2 minutes of my life and shrank the dick of every man on the planet.
Right.
It was so bad. A 10-hour delay on a response to a little girl who said, email me at small. She was just minding her own business, being a miserable cunt and trying to destroy the world on behalf of the Rothschilds and George Soros, sure. Like she is every day.
Right.
And for some reason, Andrew Tate got his unzipped his zipper. Pulled a little penis out and tried to piss on someone with 2 million more followers than him. That's the way. That's what happened.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm gonna make a name for myself. I'm gonna take my little dick out and I'm gonna piss right up the leg of this bigger account follower than me. And she said, "Yeah, go ahead and email me your list of your cars at smalldickenergy@getalife.com.
Let me give the whole thing. So
go ahead.
He tweeted what I thought was one of the stupidest tweets I've ever seen, which was like, "Hey, Greta Thunberg, noted climate activist. I believe she's a 19-year-old girl.
Yeah.
Says, look at all my cars, and they emit so much smog, and I'm polluting all the time with my cool cars." And he was like, "Why don't you give me your email so I can email you about all the cool cars?"
He ruined
I
supercars.
Own.
Supercars are now gay.
That
and
dude
lame.
Was literally the dumbest.
He has set misogyny
thing.
Forward 50 years.
Yeah. Because she just responded very quickly. She said, "Sure, email me at
smalldickenergy@getalife.com.
And you're like, "Yeah, that's pretty good." Because that was a stupid thing you posted.
Yeah, it wasn't. It was good. It was funny.
What he posted?
No, what she posted.
Yeah, what she posted was a little funny.
What he posted was miserable. What he posted was unforgivable.
Yeah, I'm like, okay, you own a bunch of cars. Hey, Greta Thunberg.
You don't. So this is what, this is my problem, is manliness coaches or manliness gurus
are not good at being manly, because that was the most womanly thing I've ever seen.
It was worse.
Look at the cool stuff I own, and you can't ever take it away from me. It's my cars, so and they're so cool.
This is my problem. I was having a meeting with a right-wing, let's just say a right-wing financier like a year and a half ago, 2 years ago, because I'm always trying to.
Uh-oh.
That's a good thing. I'm always trying to resurrect my war against the banks, right?
Sure.
Left, right, I don't care. I hate the banks. Kind of I fucking hate banks, right? Till the day I die, that's all I care about is destroying the banks. And he said, we're talking, and he goes, "Oh, yeah, what do you think about Andrew Tate, huh? Like, how does he get, he's got a lot of money, right? He's got all those cars." And I said, "Oh, bro, no. Those are all, that's all fake. Those are all, those have got to be rentals or like, owned by a Saudi that he's like, you know,
borrowing.
His buddies with." And he looked at me like I just told him Santa wasn't real. He's like, it hurt his identity.
Yeah.
I've hurt a lot of people. I know exactly how I hurt them. In the specific way and how much, right?
Right.
Like, I'm like, I can see the look on your face. Like, I just sunk your battleship, didn't I?
Yeah.
And I saw the look on his face. Like, no, that can't
be. He's the ultimate man.
There's no, what are you talking about? He's going to own fucking billions of.
Yeah,
no.
He's not making that much
money. What are you, he's a pimp.
Yeah.
Which is funny. I like it. I like the guy. I loved him until he came out on Christmas and called everyone a loser on Christmas Day.
Yeah, what
I'm like,
was
don't
that
call,
about?
Don't call men. Don't Don't call the men that you've siphoned off of all these other guys' audiences into your scam manliness seminar for $6,000 losers. Like, what the fuck is wrong? I feel like when normal people see women in an abusive relationship, they're like, "How that sucks for her," you know?
It was a really weird tweet, wasn't he? Like, you know, you guys are poor. If I had to live your lives, I would kill myself. And I'm like,
yeah, I guess you'll have a lot of time to think about that while you're in jail.
Yeah, I was like, aren't these guys paying you $60 a month for manliness courses, and you're gonna tell them that they can't possibly live a good life unless they own, I don't know, a sex dungeon and a fleet of supercars? Which
he
you
bought
don't
a supercar
own.
Rental company from some guy and ran it into the ground. Oh, that's why he lives in a warehouse next to a fucking airport, an international airport.
Yeah, he does not have like a mansion. Like, he's filming these things in like the corner of a room.
And the reason it annoyed me so much is because I went onto the Twitter and typed in Andrew Tate Matrix, and it's like guys doing blood oaths with each other, giving each other insane conspiracies about how Andrew Tate's like the Matrix is coming down on him, and he always said he was going to get arrested. Like, yeah, that's because he's probably doing a bunch of fucking crimes, bro. It's one of my other friends who is a criminal says, you know, buddy, I'm probably going to get arrested soon. I think because you've been doing crimes, right?
No,
yeah,
no, you don't
I've been
understand.
Doing crimes, as it turns out.
That's been the craziest thing is the people who go, he predicted this would happen. I'm like, he predicted what? That he was going to get arrested by the Matrix. And I'm like, if I know that I did a bunch of illegal shit and I go to you and I say like, hey, man, if I get arrested, it's part of a grand magic conspiracy. And then I get arrested. That doesn't prove that there's a grand magic conspiracy. That's not a very, it's like, it's not a called shot. He just knew he had done illegal shit.
Yeah.
And that it was eventually going to come back and fuck
him. How do you guys think you get women to, and number one, work? And number two, do sex work. Someone's got to be there beating their ass and threatening them. Yeah. They don't do that for fun. They don't work. Women don't like working.
It's been a very, and just seeing all the weird conspiracy theories. I saw a guy who goes, Andrew Tate has never talked about pizza before. Because in the video, he's like eating a pizza.
Same, I saw the same fucking thing.
So pizza must be some sort of code. Oh. And I'm like, what, you guys, I always say this about conspiracy theorists, is that you want the world to be far more interesting than it actually is. It's like, I think he just ordered a pizza because he thought it would be like a
prop. He thought it would be carbon emissions?
Yeah,
And again, I want to stress, the unforgivable sin was posting a 2-minute video.
That was not funny.
That was not funny at all to a little girl.
Yeah. Going, I know you said I have small dick energy, but since you said it was your email address, that means that you have small dick energy. And I'm like, oh, bro, just
no, I've never
stop.
Seen a woman insulted by telling her she has a small dick, let alone a little girl.
Why are you
I don't
worrying
know
about
what this is, but I don't want to be associated with it, and I hate it. And if you're defending it, shame on you.
Yeah, there's
shame on you.
He needs like a guy to be there, like probably you. To go, hey, I want to post a video where I smoke a cigar and fight with a 19-year-old girl. And you go,
yeah, I'll write you some zingers.
I'll write you three good zingers. There needed to be a zinger. I don't think he had any.
I hate it because I hate when bad things happen to vulnerable men first, more than anyone else. And that's what this is. It's men, vulnerable men. Thank you. With no friends who sign up to these manliness courses. They believe in some modicum of success because he started during like the biggest bull market in history.
Yeah.
So whatever advice you got, you profited from.
Mm.
And then they take this and this little network of friends and it gets their emotions all screwed up. And they start thinking that this guy's the Messiah, and he fucking thinks it himself, I guess. Yeah, I don't know why you would put that out thinking it was funny.
That's the problem, was when these guys start believing their own bullshit.
Yeah.
When, you know, he goes, I think these guys start off as masculinity coaches and they go, yeah, I don't know, it'll be something fun to do. And I'll just tell guys to clean their room and beat their wives.
Wash
or
their
whatever.
Penis. Yeah.
Wash your penis. Yeah. And then like, you
Which
know,
good.
People keep coming to him and they go, you've really changed my life. Washing my penis has made me more desirable. And
what
you
else
go,
you got?
Yeah. And he goes like, well, hold on. No, maybe I am a god among men.
Yeah,
maybe I can do here. Well, that was the thing, is that this tweet was clearly a man with far more confidence than he should have.
Than the whole human race put together.
A guy who has not recognized that he's not funny. and is like, I'm going to own all these bitches. Like, oh, you got to be funny if you're going to do that. You can't just be you.
Yeah, you started this, by the way. And dude, you're like losing big time.
Watching that video, like, honestly shattered the Andrew Tate. Because there was still a part of me that I'm like, all right, this guy is like, you know, kind of like a tough guy and he doesn't take no shit or whatever else. And then watching that, I was like, oh, he's like a scared little boy.
I wouldn't even be afraid to fight him now.
Yeah, dude. I
don't care.
Like, I was like, this guy's like a fucking dork.
Let's play the video.
Sure.
Because, it makes me extra sad because I had him on my show like 2 years ago.
Yeah.
I liked him because he was running the whorehouse. And I I don't care about human trafficking. Really?
Okay.
Like, I care as much as everybody else. I'm like, oh, man, I really hope it doesn't have stops. Oh, right?
It's just weird how human trafficking is such a broad definition that I never know exactly what they're talking about.
Coercion.
I'm like, yeah, I'm like, so, like, did he kidnap them? It's like, no, he just, like, convinced them.
Yeah, and then, like, you got to live here and do it. Like, okay, yeah. That's shady.
You're not allowed to leave. And I'm like, yeah, but how does he stop them from leaving? Like
usually it's holding passports. And I don't know if he's done any of this, but that's usually how it is.
Yeah. Okay.
I don't know. Honestly, I don't even care about
it. Confusing.
It's just it was just the video.
This video is worse than any amount of human trafficking. I would rather
it really is.
Get trafficked 100 women than post this.
Yeah. And the devastation in the followers, like you saw this when Jack Murphy imploded too.
Yeah.
When it turned out he was doing like
putting dildos in his butt,
which is fine, but
you gotta, that's been the whole thing. There's other guys.
It's like the BLM lady that bought all his mansions. Like, yeah well, okay, but that's like, that's fucked.
Yeah. I don't know exactly what Nick Riccate is up to, but like, there's all this stuff where I see these guys. No. I don't have my vetoes. I'm just saying, I'm like, look, if you're doing weird sex shit, just like, be upfront about it.
Yeah.
Like me, I've never hidden the fact that I've done weird, kinky things with a bunch of transsexuals. And it's like, yeah, so it's not a problem. But then these guys go like, oh, I'm hypermasculine. I would never put anything in my butt, blah, 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 blah. And then it turns out that they love putting stuff in their butt.
It's the money to me.
Yeah.
Because when you charge so much for something that's worthless, you get the people who are the most sick. Like the most sick and desperate that you're preying on. So I don't know how to explain this, but that same perverse compulsion to show off sexual, like get involved in all this degenerate sex publicly,
yeah,
is like a similar impulse to me as this preying on. I see it as a weird type of predatory, almost. I don't want to say like a homoerotic because like that's fine, whatever.
Yeah.
But it's like specifically against men, which I find very bizarre. It's not a good explanation. Let's watch the video and we can think about it.
Here's
Andrew Tate's death, sadly. He will be missed.
Release some greenhouse gases.
Oh, yeah. So this was accompanying a tweet that said, thank you for confirming via your email address that you have a small penis.
Oh, what a comeback.
But you don't have to explain.
So bad.
Via.
The world was curious. And I do agree you should get a lie. So he doubles down on the same joke.
Oh, yeah. And furthermore, in addition, the second part of your email,
vis-a-vis,
I additionally believe that you again referred to yourself.
That's the same joke twice, buddy.
Okay, that's it, right? You're done with that? Oh, no, you have a 2-minute video.
If you're
going
to post
a
video, the video should speak for itself. It should be like, my message to small penis Greta or something, and that would have been funnier. Instead, he needed this whole explanation of how he wasn't owned.
Yeah.
This is a man. It's literally a man who got owned explaining how technically he didn't get owned, which is the worst.
Which I think is the max for Twitter. So he would have gone on longer.
If you're in a situation and everyone agrees you got hyper burned, the solution is not to go, well, technically, if you read it this way, I didn't get burnt. That's not going to work. You just got to move forward and find a new tact. All right.
Just ignore it.
You can't play the reverse Uno card and go, well, you have a small penis.
You don't use the word small penis.
Yeah, well, yeah, Greta's allowed to use that because she's a teenage girl. You're a grown man. You should have better burns.
Don't use the phrase small penis in an argument with a woman ever. Okay, here it is. 2 minutes. Well, maybe we'll stop. I don't know.
No, just watch.
Some greenhouse gases. I'm obviously a stranger to online controversy. It's not something I often do. But now, the mainstream press is commenting on the fact that I was informing...
You see, does he believe... That was a joke, right?
About the press?
I'm obviously a stranger to online controversy.
Yeah,
I guess that's a little joke, right?
Yeah.
Okay. It also annoys me that he's, like, buddying up with smaller guys, like, younger guys, like Sneeko.
Yeah.
In an obvious ploy to, like, sift their additionally vulnerable fans to his $6,000 manliness.
He needs fresh blood. You got to keep replenishing the bloodstone.
Okay, here we go.
I mean, Greta, that my very extensive car collection with internal combustion engines, which run on dead dinosaurs.
I hate this guy.
Have an enormous emission profile. And she replied by telling me her own email address. Greta's email address is, I have small dick energy.
Why would you say that?
I hate this
guy. Why would you ever say that phrase?
What the fuck? It's a guy, and it's also a guy, like, she said, like, you know it's directed at you. She just phrased it. Instead of saying you have small dick energy, she did a little clever wordplay and made an email address. And you're really playing the technicality game going, well, that means it's your email address. What the fuck, man?
This is the biggest manliness coach in the world.
I will say I'm as stupid as him because I remember I thought oil came from dead dinosaurs.
Did you really?
Yeah, I don't know if I said that on the show. Oh, well, I was like, oh, fuck. Me and Andrew Tate are equally retarded.
Okay, here.
Why would that be your own email address, Greta?
Oh, God.
Strange. I mean, also, I don't want to assume her gender. It's 50-50. But
all right, now you gotta,
bro, time machine for that one.
Yeah.
Oh,
all right. So he's already established with the tweet that the email, he's done the reverse card. It's the bad play.
Uh-huh.
Did it again in the video. He's now got a minute 20 to move on from the email address thing and say something of substance.
Okay.
Let's see how long it takes for him to get away from this email thing.
How many more times can you say small penis?
Yeah.
But it is. I'm not actually mad at Greta. Please bring me pizza and make sure that these boxes are not recycled. Thank you. So I'm not actually mad at Greta, right? Because she doesn't realize she's been programmed. She doesn't realize she's a slave of the Matrix. She thinks she's doing good.
Not recycled.
Someone has
so
sat her down and convinced her to try and convince you to beg your government to tax you into poverty.
Bro, it's not funny.
To stop the sun from being
No.
And then, because I called her out on it, the Global Matrix got this bot farm
bots,
like and retweet and all this bot commenting to try and pretend that her telling me that she has a small dick and her own email address somehow teaches me a lesson.
Okay. I want to kill myself.
Welcome to a new episode of The Clown Show. But now
how
I
many
know
memes,
that
how many memes, how many more memes do you have, dear Grandpa?
Little hate-filled face. Bitter, sitting somewhere without the heating on. In the cold, a little hat, shivering. Use my tweets. We're just going to make my Twitter account far more fun into eternity.
This whole, like, it's so cool to not recycle thing. Make sure to not recycle these pizza boxes. I'm like,
got it.
Okay. Yeah. That's bad.
That wasn't a joke. The joke was small penis, though.
Yeah.
It was get a life, small penis.
I'm smoking a cigar. I'm contributing to greenhouse gas. All right.
Bro, you don't own the cars. You have a car rental warehouse next to an airport where the Saudis fly you out to fuck their whores.
Yeah.
This is...
The Saudis love this guy because he's a fighter, so when he comes in and puts on a show.
I don't know.
Saudis are great. Why can't we get a Saudi audience, by the way?
Because I hate Islam.
Yeah, I know. That's our problem. We gotta take the call to prayer
this
more
shit
seriously.
This is worse than actual religion, which I despise less.
Well, I think this is a religion. It's the religion of just idiocy.
The Liver King and his steroids. I don't know. This
were people big into
on.
The Liver King? Was that a big? Was he a big
people
deal?
I thought it was real. People were eating organs of animals thinking that they were going to get ripped. It was obviously on steroids.
Yeah.
Oh, nobody knew.
Look at
that's not an excuse. Everyone is as dumb as me is not an excuse.
Speaking of which, we got to get some steroid. Where's the steroid king? I want that guy who just goes, better lie through steroids.
I got a steroid.
Let's think about that. Let's see what happens.
You want roids, too, to go with your testosterone?
Yeah, I'm going to try everything this year, I think.
You got to try going on a walk, though, and riding a bicycle.
I don't want to try that nonsense.
No, you got to do that.
I just want to shoot up first.
Are you going to do exercise this year?
Yes, I'm going to do exercise.
What kind of exercise are you going to do?
I have my exercise bike. I'm going to go for I'm going to take your bike.
Finally. Okay. How much exercise are you gonna do?
A million.
Come up with a plan, and then we can gamify it with money.
Well,
oh, see, there your eyes light up with that.
We'll see. We'll see what happens. Let's just say there's a third party. They're not gonna do it. There's another fat.
Is it Boogie?
There's a fat gentleman who I think it would be great to go on an adventure with, but.
Is it Tony from Hack the Movies?
No, Tony's not that. Tony's not as fat as me anyway. Tony's not like a fat guy. He's like a chubby guy.
No. All right.
Anyway, we love Tony. Did you see Tony posting on Twitter? Because our last episode, we ripped on him for sitting down at the live show. He said, I'm sick in bed. I figured I would just enjoy my favorite podcast.
Yeah.
And we devoted like 2 minutes to ripping on him. Sorry, Tony. Enjoy your holidays.
I miss Andrew Tate, the humble kickboxer and pimp. I'm a religious guru.
Guys need to understand to remain elusive. This is the same problem with Elon Musk.
Yeah.
Is Elon Musk was great when it was like, you didn't really hear from him all that much.
Yeah. And don't charge, stop paying for this shit.
Andrew Tate, you got popular through TikToks, which is you condensed down to about 10 seconds. Mm-hmm. And a man condensed down to just quotes and 10-second clips can seem like a genius.
Yeah.
Because your brain fills in all the parts you're not seeing.
Yeah.
But when you give me 2 minutes of, the thing is, if that's her email address, that would mean that she's the one, and that means I don't have the energy. Her energy is of the small dick. My dick, actually quite large.
Honey, let me get a pizza. Let me get a pizza.
Now, the unconfirmed part of that story is the idea that he bought pizza from a Romanian pizza place, which confirmed he was in the country, and then he got because he immediately
I think
got
that's retarded, but
I think that's probably not that's probably not true, but it is interesting timing that immediately after posting that video, he was arrested by the Romanian authorities.
I think they saw it and just like, he's a bitch. Let's get him.
I think that honestly,
he's
I think
a
they
bitch.
Watched
he has
it,
no game at all, get
and
him.
They're like, this guy sucks.
Yeah,
let's
got
just
him.
Go fog with him.
Get him.
I think before they were like, well, you know, he's a very masculine guy. If we show up, he might do anything. And they saw that.
Yeah,
and they're like, oh, he's like a little pussy. Oh.
Yeah.
Let's
arrest him.
Let's go arrest
him. Let's kill him. Let's take pictures of his wiener.
Yeah.
He's talking about small dicks all the time.
Well, I know some guys are, you know, taking the sexual trafficking allegations very strong. There's a guy I follow on Twitter. He's got like a whole thread. So I'll trust their judgment.
Nick Monroe.
Yeah, Nick Monroe. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, the problem with Andrew Tate is, so many people just hate him because he fucks hot girls that it's hard to say that he sucks.
Yeah.
Now, because like you're siding with them. So it's like, well, I don't want to side with you guys. Like, I don't care how he treats women.
So he runs a brothel?
Nah, it's just like a cam whore something.
Okay.
I don't know.
But the allegation is that for some reason these women aren't allowed to leave or something.
Well, how do you take 60% of a cam whore's money and it's not like intimidation.
Yeah, don't take 60%.
It's not possible.
That's
I don't
predatory.
Believe you. Oh, we're taking 60% of their money. Okay, so because you'll throw them out, have all this. What are you talking about? I don't fucking believe you at all. Oh, this bitch just walks the street for me and fucks guys and then gives me 60% of her money. Why? No reason.
Well, I'll tell
I'm
you.
I'm just a nice guy.
Yeah. It's, I mean, there's a lot of guys out there who want to pay for that sort of thing, I guess.
Yeah.
They all want to spill their load. Which leads me into my problem, Dick.
Okay.
My problem is semen. I don't like it. And there's a number of reasons.
Interesting.
Semen is a viscous, creamy, slightly yellowish or grayish substance made of spermatozoa, commonly known as sperm, and a fluid called seminal plasma. Frankly, I just don't like this stuff, Dick.
Okay.
Because first of all, it's disgusting. Is it cum just gross?
I mean,
I've only
dealt with my own, so not
it,
really.
Yeah, but it is gross. Even your own cum, you're okay with it?
Yeah, I guess.
It's got
I'm not like, get this stuff off of me.
It's got that weird like consistency where it's like kind of wet, but kind of not. It's like, what is it?
Come on.
And it gets everywhere. You can't control it coming out. All right.
Well, you can kind of control it.
Yeah, but not really. I've spent my I've spent my whole life trying to control this stuff, and I still it's unpredictable. It just goes, it comes out in odd ways, and then what do you do with it? You just want to jerk off, but you got to find like a tissue or a sock or something to get rid of it. It's just obnoxious.
What would you prefer? You need like a woman.
I think it should, like, if it was like a solid thing that came out.
Like a Tic Tac?
Yeah, like a Tic Tac.
Like a Pez?
Like you ejaculated a Pez and then you could just pick it up and deal with it.
Okay, so you just have a problem with the form that it's in.
The thing is, Dick, but to get more serious, semen has a lot of problems for our modern society. Now, semen is one of the primary ways to transfer STDs, Dick.
I thought you were going to say they catch rape victims.
Well, that's
that's another problem.
Well, that's the other thing. Why does it have your DNA in there? Why do they need? Yeah, why am I always leaking a puddle of DNA?
Oh, yeah.
When I just want to commit sex crimes.
So,
Dick, more than 1 million sexually transmitted infections are acquired every day worldwide. And that includes HIV and AIDS. And it's being spread through the semen.
I didn't know that.
Well, what do you mean you didn't know that?
I thought it was just in blood. AIDS.
No, it can be transferred through your semen, of course.
I didn't know that. Course. I thought it was only a gay thing.
No, heterosexual and homosexuals can obtain.
Yeah, I thought that was like drug use, though.
No.
So a straight man having vaginal sex with a woman can give her AIDS with his semen?
Yeah.
I don't think that can't be right.
Well, now I feel like I have to look it up, but I'm pretty sure that's true.
What are the odds of that?
I don't know. But it's like, it's not just blood.
I didn't know that.
Well, now we got to look it up because now you got me doubting it. Dick, and it is also, did you know this, possible to have a semen allergy?
Oh, yeah. They've tried that one on me before.
Oh, yeah. Well, this is a rare condition that is more common in women.
Actually, I put a bunch of cum in your drink and you don't seem to be reacting to that poorly. So
up to 40,000 women suffer from semen allergies. Which can cause allergic reactions such as redness, burning, swelling, pain, hives, and itching. And in severe cases, you can even cause anaphylaxis. You can choke to death because of semen, Dick.
What?
Wouldn't it be better if we could just, like, copulate in a way that we didn't have, like, our fucking balls full of this goo?
No, I think it should actually be more.
You think there
what
should
would
be
the difference
semen?
Between men and women without men shooting a bunch of cum everywhere? It's pretty much the only difference, you know, physiologically.
I'm saying
it should be coming all the time.
It's not
you should have to go around with a trash bag rubber banded to your cock.
It seems like an unreliable method of reproduction is that you gotta.
It's part of the. That's a feature, buddy.
Yeah, but.
That just
you don't want
Ralph.
It to work very well. Yeah. That's a good point. Shouldn't we be able to, like, you know, choose specifically as opposed to randomly splashing an egg?
Yeah, you would think
with
so.
Our semen?
Yeah.
It's so random. You know, and you don't even know. And then there's, of course, the problem of the dribblers and the shooters. And the dribbler can't even shoot it as high up as they want. So they can't even coat that egg. You know, the girls
got... They wriggle and bounce. They don't squirt on the
girl's got to, like, go upside down so the cum trickles down into her.
I'm going to throw up.
Exactly! Because cum's disgusting!
No, because the woman. I'm imagining a woman in that position with her tits all hanging the wrong way.
I've just always thought that cum, it's gross, it's full of sperm.
It's cum until it's on her, then it's a mess. Go clean it up.
The idea that I'm walking around and I got a bunch of little snakes, like, swimming around, And then the way to make a baby is I shoot a load of little snakes inside a lady, and whichever snake is fastest gets to be a baby.
Can you please go to a drag queen story hour and give that biology lesson? You have a little bunch of little snakes in you.
You do. You have a bunch of little tadpoles at all times just living in you, which is fucking weird. And then a girl goes, please shoot your little tadpoles inside me. Why would you want that? Of all, I would go on a surface level. Like if I was a lady and a guy said, "I want to shoot a load of little baby tadpoles inside you," I'd go, "No." I'd go, "What is wrong with you? That's disgusting." And I go, "No, because one of them might swim all the way inside you and make a baby, or just give you AIDS or some shit. I don't know what's going on."
You know, this is the worst. This is the worst thing I've ever heard.
But you agree it's gross.
Well, the stuff you're saying is gross because it's not real. It's like snakes and tadpoles.
Well,
and your
what else
scrotum.
Do you want to say that fucking sperm are? They're little
semen.
They're little living like bugs or some shit.
I don't know if they're living.
That you're just constantly. Honestly, I don't know why I don't get my balls chopped off. It's disgusting that I constantly.
You see why guys turn to Andrew Tate?
Because
they go to their comedy podcast and they're talking about snakes in their balls that they need to chop their balls off.
How awful is it that I used to be a little snake in someone else's balls? Like, the problem is, you know, it used to, like when you're a kid, you're like, yeah, God, that makes sense. They, you know, the guy created everything. And then you learn that the way babies are made is that a guy shoots a load of snakes inside a lady. And you go, there's no way there's a God. Because he would have come up with a way more magical fucking experience than 1,000 little baby snakes fighting.
I agree with you.
Yeah. Wouldn't he?
Especially the snake. It would be like a dove or something.
Yeah.
Be thousands
or like an
of doves.
Energy orb that like you transfer to a lady.
An apple.
Yeah.
You'd come an apple.
I would think
and
God
shoot it in her and it would be a baby.
That's the ultimate argument against religion. Like if a religious guy goes, well, I know there's a God because this and this, you go, okay, well, explain why I have a million little snakes in my balls that I shoot inside
a
lady.
Is that in the Bible?
Yeah, it's not in the Bible. And that's the problem. In fact, in the Bible, the snake was evil. So every time, well, actually, maybe that does tie in. I mean, that's why sex is bad under the Christian religion, because you're filling a woman with snakes.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
That's the only smart thing you've said so far.
I'm just glad that we were able to find a way through this problem. Point is, Dick,
why did you come up with this? How long have you been wanting to bring semen in? And you have cum on your paper.
Yeah, I wrote just cum.
You've always had a distaste for semen?
Yeah.
What about when you were blowing that that penis?
I didn't let it come in my mouth.
That sucks.
I don't want it. Why does that suck?
What do you think?
I don't want anyone to come in my mouth.
What about other people's mouths?
They can come, you know, outside of my mouth.
What about would you come in someone else's mouth?
I discourage it.
How?
Well, I mean, I basically
don't let me come in your mouth.
I don't force, you know, I don't go to a girl and go, you know, like, hey, you know, you should really suck on my dick, you know, whatever.
It's not like that, you know.
If she offers, I'll go like, all right, but that's, you know, it's your funeral. Because once you got a mouthful of snakes, I don't know what you want to do with it. If you want to swallow them, if you want to spit, I would spit them out, frankly.
If Boogie had done this show instead of you, we'd be talking about his dad's cum in his mouth.
Yeah, we'd be talking about all the rape and the molestation. So we're talking about how I explain to girls, I go, listen, whatever you want to do.
It's up to you. But, I'm going to be in there and playing video games.
That's
if
why
you
I'm always so weirded out when a girl doesn't want me to use a condom. I'm like, what is wrong with you? Why would you want that inside you?
Come?
Yeah.
Well, they don't want to come inside. Well,
some girls do. Some girls really do.
Yeah.
And whenever I orgasm after sex, first thing I do, I go to the bathroom and I wash my dick because I don't want it covered.
But it's your own cum.
No, I don't like it.
If you fart,
it has
like
the worst.
Oh, I gotta, ew, gross. I gotta get out of here.
No, because like a fart, it doesn't have that like that slick, weird consistency.
It's excrement.
And I don't
It's much worse. It's supposed to be.
No, that's got like little like air. It's like little particles or whatever. And also, there's not a bunch of snakes in my farts.
Particles
so
of shit.
That's fine. I don't have like
there
a
might
bunch
be.
Of
You might have worms.
Little worm babies. Just hanging out. How is that not the most disgusting thing in the world? Sperm is so fucking weird.
It's cool. It like wiggles. It's like smooth, like a new car.
It's like when you're a kid and you find out you have like a million mites living in your eyelashes or whatever.
Yeah.
Doesn't that drive you insane? You're like, oh, God.
No.
Being alive is disgusting.
Yeah.
And the most disgusting aspect of it is the cum. And that's my problem.
So you'd rather shoot when you shoot no cum.
I want to shoot an energy.
You're like awesome
into a yeah.
Well, sometimes when you come so much and nothing comes out, you're like, oh, awesome.
If I could have the thrill of a true orgasm without having to carelessly spill my seed like a like an animal, that would be the ideal situation.
What about like Peter North videos? You're watching porn. The guy's just like blah, blasting cum
it's
all
horrifying.
Over.
I think when I was a kid, I must have been scarred because I remember I went over like a neighbor's house and the dad was like, yeah, you can use the computer or whatever. You know,
the story gets worse and worse.
Shut up. What, my dad was like, had to go somewhere. So he left me at some dude's house. Shut up. And dude was like, yeah, you can
this
play.
This is when you developed your aversion to cum?
Well, he was like, yeah, you can play on the computer or whatever. I'm going to go do something else. And then like, his, you know, he had a bunch of like porn bookmarks but I had never seen a guy. So I was just clicking around. And then I just saw a guy like just erupt like a shit ton of cum out of his dick. And I was like a young kid. I'd never like all I'd ever done is piss at that point. And I was like, what the fuck is wrong with that guy's dick? What the fuck is coming out of it? Oh, because it wasn't pee. And it was like a huge cum shot.
How huge?
I don't. I remember.
Was it on a woman?
I guess so. I don't know. I just remembered being.
Was the mouse all slimy while you were using it?
No. I just remember being mortified. I go.
How'd
well,
you
I,
find the porn bookmarks?
I he must have like left like a tab open. I don't remember.
Hmm.
I don't remember being mortified curious. And going, well, if my penis ever does that, I'll kill myself.
Why are you mortified by a guy's dick?
Cause I didn't know it was like weird, like how much fucking like just this random shit was coming out of it, and it was like too much. I thought it looked like Nickelodeon slime was spilling out of the fucking.
Yeah, that was the best part of Nickelodeon. Seeing all those girls sliming. Getting slimed.
There's a lot of
having the guys be like, ah, no.
There's a lot
not
of
funny.
Slime compilations on YouTube. I used to know a girl who was on All That.
Yeah,
like the bad last season. She was like, yeah, the slime fans are the worst. Because they'll send you like, they'll be like, hey, remember an episode, season 6, episode 19, where they really slimed you? How did that feel? How did it feel to have all that slime all over you? She's like, I don't know. It didn't feel good. Like, yeah, I bet yeah. You.
Was
I bet
it warm?
You, was it warm?
Was it warm, the slime?
Did you like how much slime was... Really fucked up
What about
kids.
The fake cum? Like the Japanese cum shot.
Is that fake? The boot? Well, they what from off camera? They like splasher.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, that's the worst.
Well, you don't like that either.
That is the most.
There's no snakes in it.
It's still
opening like a can of.
God, that bukkake shit is. Oh, why would
you
want
that?
I don't understand why anybody would want cum on them.
Well, you want it on the woman because it's degrading to her, and you get off on lowering her.
Yeah, but then just piss on her.
Too much.
Well, that's too
degrading.
Much.
Too degrading. Too degrading.
Piss to me is
the piss is waste, though.
Yeah.
The cum is like not.
Cum is waste.
Not really. Not the same. Not in the same way.
Not the same way. No, and we did learn that pee is toxic, even though I thought it was sterile.
Oh, it's toxic?
Well, it has like some bacteria in it.
Oh, okay.
Cum.
Press 1 in the chat if you're totally. If Vito ruined cum for you.
I'm just saying, if I offered you an alternative, would you take it?
To shooting cum out of my cock? Like, if you wanted me to shoot Jolly Ranchers?
For the rest of your life, instead of shooting cum, you just don't shoot cum. How's that?
No.
Nothing comes
I don't
out.
Want that.
Why not?
Because I enjoy shooting cum on women. What do you mean?
I don't
it's,
get it.
If there's nothing coming out, it's like, oh, that was pointless.
You want to paint her face.
paint everything.
I disagree. I like a girl. I don't want her to have any fluids.
I'll come in a sock and then think about the cleaning lady grabbing it and go like, hey.
Oh, I hate that. You ever come in a sock and then you go to come in a sock again and you realize it's the same sock you already cummed in?
Yeah.
What do you mean? Yeah, that's the worst. That's the worst. No, but like
I don't go out of my way looking
for
it.
But I'm saying it's still wet with the cum from the first time that you busted in it.
Yeah, I understand. Or dry. I'm like, oh shit.
Yeah. Well, I don't want to double up on a cum sock.
Are you this way with blood too?
No, blood's fine.
Blood's fine.
Cum's like the only
fluid.
Even
though it's full of AIDS.
Cum's. I mean, yeah, that's pretty bad, but blood's cool. Cum's like the only bodily fluid that I'm truly just like.
It's not.
I can't deal with this.
Throw up.
Throw up's really bad.
Okay.
Yeah. That's just because I've had some terrible vomiting situations myself. I got food poisoning like twice this year.
Oh. Well,
and just like the worst vomiting.
What are you eating?
Well, the first.
Fast food?
The first time was a guy invited me to a fancy dinner and he ordered the seafood tower, which was like raw oysters and shit. And one of those oysters must have
You don't
been
like cum, but you're eating fucking raw oysters with strange men? Okay.
He's not a strange man. Oh, he's kind of strange. That I got a bad oyster. The second time, I don't know what it was. But God, you ever have that like that fucking
food poisoning, yeah.
Yeah, but you get that like that violent throw up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like it though.
Shut the fuck up. No way.
Yeah, because it's like look at all these calories. Just getting rid of them.
Oh no, that's like normal throw up is great. I normal throw up every day.
Even when you're throwing up like it's violently, it's like I'm getting a great ab workout. Like
oh dude, it really does fuck up your abs. Yeah. It's crazy. So yeah, cum. It's just gross.
Okay. Semen.
It's the worst problem.
A retarded problem.
I wrote these problems last night at 7 a.m.
That's too much time.
I spent too much time working on the stinger.
You should do every other time as a stinger.
I'll figure it out.
My problem is I forget where it is. It's shoulder nipples.
Mm.
I pulled a sweater out of my closet for sweater season.
Yeah.
Fucking big old nipples on that shit.
What is that from? From the
hanger.
From the hanger.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What am I supposed to do going around? Big
Can't
old?
You smooth it out?
How?
Pull it down
Shoot
a
bunch
bit.
Of cum all over. Pull it
Shoot
down
some,
a little
yeah,
bit.
Yeah, use cum to like, get it into place.
It's poking up. I'm walking around looking like Guar. My nice
Can't
long
you use an
sleeve.
Iron? Can't you iron it? Do you have an iron?
I do now.
You know you could iron it. Talking about I got a bullshit
It's all
problem.
Messed up. It's all messed up. You can't iron one part of your shirt.
Yes, you can.
No, it will. You'll. It's like a cartoon where something's about to move. And you're like, that fucking apple's about to move, and then it moves. And like, it's the wrong fucking color. It's like that with shirts, too. It's just a big, damp spot.
Do you put your T-shirts on hangers?
No. Sweaters. I just said
sweater.
A fucking sweater.
Okay.
A long-sleeve sweater. Sits in the closet
like
for a year.
You could have brought it to emphasize.
Well, what, are you going to bring some cum for us to?
I have it right now. We all have Let's go. Let's go.
What
Present
if your cum
it.
Is, like, extra gross? And that's why
I should have shot some cum into a thing. You ever like, yeah, that's the other thing. You ever like these people who like drink cum?
You should cum on a picture of Melanie Mack.
These people
and
who
post that.
These
I bet she would love it.
Fantasize about drinking cum. I'll get a little Melanie Mack figure and I'll put it in a jar.
Yeah, the guy, Maned Wolf called into my show who got all those like 20 guys to
come on
a
pizza.
Yeah, it was the most disgusting.
And you know, that was
thing.
Disgusting.
Well, yeah.
So are you pretending cum's not disgusting?
Well, just like my own cum coming on my hand,
yeah,
and versus 20 strange men coming on a pizza, is just different to me.
I just
I don't
think
know
all
why.
Cum
I
is
can't
gross.
Quantify it.
Even my own cum, Qualify I don't like it.
Shoulder nipples.
Shoulder
you ever
nipples.
Had any clothing ruined by shoulder nipples, Fido?
Well, I mean, I have stuff hanging on hangers, but
it's all ruined. And then. It's not even, the worst part isn't even getting the shoulder nipples on your sweaters. It's going to hang stuff up and knowing that there will be shoulder nipples when you get back. Because the hangers only go, for no reason, they only go to here. Even though
if it went the full length, it would create less of a divot.
Yeah. I have hangers I have hangers.
Dick, our audience is not hanging up their clothes. They're all a bunch of douchebags wearing t-shirts and jeans.
Coming on themselves?
None of them are wearing a fancy holiday sweater.
Where do they get the money then? We've got a ton of paying people paying for the show. Those guys those guys have money. They're hanging up their clothes.
Well, hopefully they're not buying sweaters.
Your
they
fans
be reinvesting
aren't hanging.
In the show.
I have...
And they're investing in strategies to avoid getting cum on themselves.
Your hangers last 50 fucking years. You're telling me that you can't have like a nice hanger that has cups at the end, like red Solo cups at the end to make the shoulders?
Are you telling me you want to reinvent the coat hanger?
Yeah.
Maybe
I'm tired of getting shoulder nipples.
Maybe you're just buying shitty sweaters.
No, this is a real, this is a regular problem that everyone has.
Then I should be able to Google it and find results. And I don't think I'll be
think
able
you
to.
Are. Yeah.
I don't think anyone is
yeah.
complaining.
Hold on.
I look for coat hanger ruined
shoulder
sweater.
Shoulder nipples.
Shoulder nipples is obviously not going to show up.
Look. No,
sweater
number
nipple
one.
Marks.
Fuck you.
How is that actually
sweater
a thing?
Nipple marks.
Okay, wait. Go
what
down.
What do you not hang your clothes up?
I just don't notice. I guess I don't have a lot of sweaters, though. Does this have a nipple? I don't fucking know.
Yeah, why don't you text me a picture of your closet when you get home?
No.
Let's
the horrible
see this dumb lady?
Okay, no, but like, what is there solutions?
No, there's no solutions.
How to avoid shoulder nipples?
That's a scam. That's a scam.
No, apparently.
That's a crypto scam link. I know it a mile away. Properly fold and hang. This is from the alphaman.com. website.
Why don't you use some alpha? Yeah, maybe use some alpha male strategies to avoid.
No,
shoulder
I don't trust alpha.
Maybe
men.
If you paid Andrew Tate, he would tell you how to avoid. But who cares? Who's looking at your sweater and sees these little bumps?
Look at how ugly it is.
I don't even
look at this lady. Look at how ugly
oh,
she
look
is.
Look at this 100x100
disgusting
JPEG you found.
Disgusting woman. Look at this guy.
So it's a little bump. Who cares?
Looks like you have a tumor.
This is the stupidest problem. This is worse than cum.
No.
By a long shot.
No, everyone has shoulder nipples.
Oh, I live in a top of a mansion and fucking I live in LA. Oh, but I got little bumps in my sweater. Oh, there's little bumps. Oh my God, this is as bad as children starving and people getting shot in the head.
It's way worse.
Tiny little fucking bumps.
See, look
from
at this. This guy's got, he put water on his shoulder to get rid of the nipple.
Okay, so
and you can
a,
still see it.
So you can use
you can
regular water
it.
To fix it, is what I'm
and
hearing.
And this lady has an actual nipple on her shoulder.
Oh, I don't know what that's
That's
about.
Weird. Look at all these pictures of shoulder nipples. Exactly what I'm talking
okay.
about. See? See?
Oh my
look,
God.
Because hangers are made for women. That's why. Not for men. Women are always complaining that we're not putting our clothes away.
Yeah.
That we're just putting them on the floor, not putting them in the hamper, because nothing is made for us. Give me a hanger that's this wide. I'll put it on. I'll use it.
I tried to get a bank loan for the orphanage, you know, and the guy said, I'm sorry, sir. We don't serve those with shoulder nipples here. You know, it's a real crisis out
yeah,
there.
Yeah, well... Zelensky didn't have shoulder nipples in his sweater that he
perfectly
that he talked to Congress in. I looked.
This is retarded.
This is the first thing I looked for.
You gonna bring in loose threads next time? Ooh, what about when a button falls off your coat,
no.
folks? You ever? Oh, then you gotta sew the button back on. This is the stupidest. What a waste of my time.
All right, go ahead.
My problem, Dick. I sent you a link as
oh,
an
yeah,
example.
Sorry.
I was scrolling around my Twitter recently. And I saw a page from the new Starfire comic book. Starfire, famously one of the Teen Titans, now just a Titan, no longer a teen.
Okay.
Thankfully.
Yeah.
Whatever.
So now
we're
good.
Going there. And they've apparently changed
name?
Her costume. It was the same exact thing I sent you the stinger in. It hit number one.
Don't fucking take that tone with me.
Listen, right. Grandpa. Trying to look up shoulder nipples and can't even find an example. All right, now I got two.
Oh,
I got
yeah,
two
okay.
here.
Right.
You're gonna see the difference. So on the left, click on it real quick. If you can click on the left picture, yeah, it'll yeah. zoom in on it. So that's Starfire. You know Starfire,
hot.
Right?
Yeah,
it's hot. She's a hot alien lady. She's got the hot pants. You get to see her legs.
You can see a little bit of that pussy.
You get
line
that ingrain,
down here.
Inguinal fold. That's what that's called.
Linguini fold.
Inguinal.
Inguinal.
I believe it's inguinal fold.
Baby, let me
fold
get my...
The,
I'm going to lick your inguinal
I
fold.
I want that inguine. I'm all about that inguine.
I don't want that vagine.
I don't want the vagine. Give me that inguine. Exactly.
It's the inguinal fold?
Let's see. I believe you. We'll have to look it up later.
It's grosser than cum.
Dude, she was wearing these fucking this bottom, right? And you could totally see her inguine. She had that inguinal fold right there. And let's see how much inguine we see on the new costume if we scroll through. Where's the inguine? There's nothing. There's no skin at all. The only skin is her fucking knuckles.
Why is she wearing a loincloth for a man?
I don't know. And see that green part where, like, her boots meet? They couldn't even leave her legs there.
There's no ass dent at all.
There's nothing. There's no skin. And this is the desexification of media, Dick.
Yeah.
And that is my problem.
The war on sexiness.
It's basically, yes, that we understood that certain types of media were made for
that's
men. That's just a, and it's not demeaning. Does that, do you look at that and you go, yeah, that fucking whore, I'm going to rail that. You're like, no,
yeah,
she's strong. Well, yeah, I want to rail her, but
I would come all over.
If she wanted to kick some
her
ass,
ingweens.
I'd cover that ingween in snakes. And now, shut up. And now they take it away from us. We understood that this is the comic books, video games, action movies.
What's wrong with her tits?
These were for men. This is media for men. And for some reason, they've decided we're not allowed to look at women anymore. I don't know why they've decided this.
Where's your skeleton?
I don't know. I'm hoping this is like a temporary, like, I couldn't find out if this is like her, you know, new permanent outfit or this is like a temporary addition. But I was like, this just looks terrible. Even if it is like battle armor, why not make her, at least let her legs, let a little leg show through.
Yeah.
Show me a little something. I had a second link in that email as well to give you another example of what they're doing to our characters.
Okay.
But I had a list here. I mean, Laura Croft.
Yeah.
Used to be sexy. Now she's just ugly. Tifa, famously with the boobs getting shrunk. I think that's a thing. I know that affected Dick.
It's the worst thing that ever happened.
And the mods aren't helping. I've been watching the Final Fantasy mods. They're not getting the boobs big.
No, because it changed. She wouldn't walk the same.
You're right.
She
would need different back problems. So hit that second one real quick. This was just the
this
ultimate
is your example.
This is
that
the
you
ultimate
brought
downgrade,
in?
Dick. Let's be real.
Lola Bunny.
You had Lola Bunny. Look at the curves in the first picture. She's got clear breasts. In the second one, she looks like a guy. Look at that.
Well, what's up with these, like,
she looks mannish
shorts down here? Like, is that extra we don't want to show?
Oh, yeah, you can't even show any legs. She has to wear pants under her pants.
Do you think there's going to be less furries in 20 years or in 10 years?
Maybe this might be a strategic decision to try and limit the growth
furries?
Of the furry community.
Hmm.
Because, look, originally you shot her midriff and everything. I mean, look, come on. Lola Bunny's she's a fox. She's not a bunny.
Hmm.
She's a fox. The Mortal Kombat games.
Why her eyes are all crooked. Hot.
Yeah, well, she's because she's doing that, like, you know, sizing you up kind of thing. she's okay. Thinking about she might want to dress you up like a woman, like Bugs Bunny. We can't even get a sexy green M&M anymore, Dick. Did you see they changed the green M&M?
No.
Oh, really? Google that real quick.
Green.
The green M&M, famously the most bangable M&M. We all knew it. She had
the other ones are guys.
Isn't there another lady one?
Oh, is there?
Maybe I'm wrong. Regardless, she used to have... There you go. It even shows the difference in that first picture. So she used to have those fuck me heels. All right?
Okay.
And now they've given her, like, flats.
Voice actress applauds.
Well, the voice actress says she's happy. Look, we don't get any leg from the M&M. They've covered that up. We don't get any arm. And they took off her fuck me heels and they put her in fucking tennis shoes. I can't even fuck the M&M anymore.
And she's standing like a dump.
And she used to have those pouty lips. I mean, come on, guys.
It's just her expression. She just looks shitty.
Yeah. She used to be a strong... sexy lady.
Yeah.
And now they're taking it away from us.
Now she looks like trash.
And this is all about, of course, empowering the next generation of women. They aren't meant to be eye candy. They're not meant for you. They were meant for me. And taking this away is a tragedy.
Yeah.
I want my candies to look like I could have sex with them. All right. I want the Snickers bar to have big fucking titties on it. Okay. That's the America I want.
Okay.
If I'm going to be forced to shoot this disgusting cum load everywhere, I should at least be given something nice to look at.
Yeah, I agree.
They just keep giving me all this bullshit.
I'm trying to find that post you did where you're asking for people to tell you.
Go down a little more. I'm sure it's there.
More?
Right below that Starfire one. I posted, what are some famous examples of fictional characters who had their skin covered up or boob size reduced to fit modern standards? I had the example here of Lara Croft from Tomb Raider. They used to have a nude calendar for her back in the day.
Nude?
Not nude, but like nude. A sexy. They had like an image where she was nude, but you couldn't see anything.
Oh.
And those were like official Tomb Raider images. I mean, you can see, look at that cleavage hanging out, those famous triangle boobs. And now she's just kind of a generic, I don't know, empowered lady.
Like a softball player.
They fucked up Tomb Raider. Tomb Raider would be huge right now if they had kept making Lara Croft like
hot,
smoking fucking hot, instead of making her into like a generic action heroine. I'm like, well, why don't I play this? I feel like there's a bunch of what it looks like fucking Hunger Games. What? She's Katniss? I don't care.
I really just don't care about, like, if you're making me play a game where it's like a dumpy looking woman that I have to like stop from getting killed, I just don't care as much.
There's that new game Horizon and everybody's like, why does nobody play Horizon? I'm like, because she's kind of like a fat chick. If that chick was super hot, I'd probably be playing that Horizon game.
Mm-mm. Make the bad guy a fat chick. Now you're talking.
There you go. Power Girl with her famous boob window costume, which is great. Got the boobs hanging out. Now has been changed to whatever the fuck that is. With the triangle of not allowed to see my boobs.
Wow, she's got two layers on the boobs.
Two
now.
Layers to make sure. No, and no.
Dang.
Again, they always cool. cover up the legs. Remember, it used to be every superheroine.
She should be in a hijab, though.
Yeah, well, that's true. Why not just cover them up head to toe at this point? I asked if it was temporary. We didn't know.
Samus.
It looks like they kind of reduced her boob size a little bit.
A little bit. That's a fucking 9/11 that they reduced
these
towers.
They knocked that down. They knocked down those towers. That's a tragedy.
Why do they do this?
I don't know why they're doing it. I think they think they're gonna like get in trouble or like someone's gonna complain. Because I mean, I guess these people do always complain. There's the fan. Yeah, you're like, look at how.
Yeah, there's better examples of Tifa than this one on the right.
No, but I mean, those are still obviously larger than this sports bra.
Dumb.
Training bra looking thing she's got on the left there. Here in the Smash Brothers game, they had to change her costume for the game. Again, they always cover up the legs and the boob window.
But they show guys with like their Ryu has like a big.
Oh, yeah, you get to see his abs. But they always say, well, women don't care about that. I'm like,
why?
Yeah. Women don't objectify men the
way
they wouldn't
even put my. In the game, they put Terry.
That's true. They would not put my
Fudge Packer
from Fatal Fury because they said she was too much for the game. Oh, God. What did they do
they
to Shiva
Goro's,
or whatever?
Oh, yeah. Shiva from Mortal Kombat into a WNBA player.
Disavow.
She not? She'd be great.
Yeah.
She has four arms.
Be Duncan. What was the next one? Hit the arrow there on the picture. Has a bunch of images. Anyway, is that Zendaya as from MJ?
But that's not sexiness.
Yeah, that's a little different. The evolution of Cortez. Oh, this one is horrible. Remember the Dark Queen from Battletoads?
Yeah, that bitch was hot.
Look at that. And then this is, I think, like they tried to make a cartoon.
What the fuck? There's no tits at all.
There's nothing. Yeah, you're right. Not even a bump.
Not even the suggestion of tits.
I mean, this is obviously.
And his thighs are all fucked up.
It's a bit related to a previous problem, the criminalization of heterosexuality, where you, the man, are not allowed.
I don't know why someone posted two identical pictures of Elliot Page.
Yeah, Elliot Page
right
looks
next
great.
To each other. He looks great in both of them.
The point is, guys, that this is what they're taking away from you. You knew you wanted to fuck that M&M, and they won't let you
This
have
is what
it.
They took away from you.
This
it's
is the Matrix
stock.
At work, my friends. You want to talk about the Matrix? This is the fucking Matrix.
What even is his accent?
Andrew
Tate?
You want
to talk about the Matrix?
You want to talk about the Matrix?
The Matrix is going to arrest me soon.
Don't recycle those pizza boxes.
Hey, Give me a pizza. Don't recycle the pizza boxes. So anyway, Gretel. Gretel. Because I suck this cock. So you told me that I had small penis energy.
But technically
you're saying that email. You have it. You have the small penis energy. In my mini sports cars, I was telling you that I also have a life. You don't have a life.
She has what a fucking idiot.
He ruined it. It was the stupidest thing. The initial post was bad enough, and then you just take the L and you move on. But if you try to double down, you're going to get destroyed.
Yeah.
What he should have done is he should have grabbed a picture of the green M&M, beat off real quick, and then in his post-nut clarity went, you know what?
Yeah.
I'm moving on.
He didn't come. That's the problem. He had 10 hours to come, and he didn't come.
That's another big problem of come. Is that it clouds your judgment.
You know what? I'm kind of glad, though, because I found, like, his whole, like, I play chess. First of all, smart people don't play chess.
Mm.
Smart people play Magic the Gathering.
Yes.
They don't play chess.
Or Go.
Only posers and slurs play chess.
Yes.
And
homeless black guys play chess in the park for money.
Yeah.
So that's how you know.
Chess. It's fucking cool.
I mean, homeless people of all colors.
This guy goes like this. This guy. Oh, real cute game. A computer can beat that, right? Oh, yeah. A computer can't be magic. So have fun with your little fucking computer game.
If homeless guys can become masters of it, it's not.
It's not that great.
It's not that great.
The little boy plays it. Okay. Yeah, oh, how much did that piece cost? Oh, it came with the board?
Your grandmaster is a 14-year-old boy? Okay.
Cool.
Nice.
What a baller you are that you all your pieces cost the same amount of money. You fucking F-slap! And he doesn't drink.
At all?
No. And when anybody who doesn't drink falls, I love it. Because
I'm sure he's one of these guys who also preaches, like, you shouldn't be drinking or something for clarity or whatever the fuck.
I don't know. I haven't heard that.
But you just.
But if you were hungover, you would never make a dumb video where you're like fake ordering pizzas, because you're gonna be eating pizzas.
Yeah.
I can't believe I said that to Greta Thunberg last night. Oh fuck.
It was really weird. Where he goes, bring those pizzas in. I'm like, oh, the pizzas you prepared as a prop for this.
Are they cold?
Yeah.
Are other people there waiting for the pizzas?
I feel like I need an explanation of that video because it just is him. Being humiliating.
It's like a snuff film that someone filmed
themselves.
It's like watching
him kill himself, yeah.
Okay.
What a show, Dick.
Oh, shit. Did I get voicemails this week?
I don't know. But our problems this week were... Come.
No, I didn't.
The desexification of media.
Okay, hold on.
Shoulder nipples.
Shoulder nipples and... manliness gurus,
manliness matrix,
manliness gurus. I hate them all.
We all hate them. They're all.
If you're selling advice, it's bad advice.
You're a bad, bad man.
Yeah,
and you're driving people crazy. Guys, don't forget to vote on all the problems. At biggestproblem.show, where you can, of course, vote it up, as the song reminds you.
Yeah.
And also, we'll be doing our bonus episode. I'm going to try and get it out on the first of the month of the new year. It will be the biggest problem in 2022, a retrospective of the year.
Yeah.
And I'm going to have to take a look. We're going to see what the top 10 problems from the year were. We'll have to
What do I think
get
I did
the list.
Fucking vote the voicemails already. Am I going crazy?
I don't know. Did you do them or not?
I guess not. Okay, here.
So after about 10 years, I decided that I was finally going to go to the dentist. I started getting dental insurance like a year or two ago, never used it. So I was like, hey, I got this free tooth cleaning every year, so why not go? So I fucking show up once. And instead of cleaning my teeth, started doing all these fucking x-rays and shit. I'm like, well, this is weird, but whatever. Maybe they need to do it. They asked me to come back a second time. I come back a second time, and they go, hey, your teeth, they look good, but also they're fucked. You're going to have to get $1,500 worth of work done to them. And I'm like, what? Why am I paying this fucking dental insurance? And I'm like, okay, I don't want to pay that right now, so I guess I'll go. And they're like, okay, you owe us $350.
You owe us $350.
So I pay $350 for them to just fucking play around in my mouth and not even clean my goddamn teeth that I'm supposed to be getting for fucking free.
Yeah.
Fuck you, Vito.
I really, fuck you. Why is there not like a law that like the doctor has to tell
there
you?
There is. That was my fucking problem. Lack of transparency in hospital pricing. That's the fucking.
But I'm saying like, yeah, there is that.
I brought
law.
That in.
I know, but like, as you're like before they X-ray your mouth, can't they just go, listen, this is gonna cost $350.
Swipe your card here. Oh no.
Yeah.
No.
Like you have to tell me that you're gonna charge for this.
Yeah.
Are you allowed to be like, well, you didn't tell me you were going to charge for it, so I'm not paying? Like,
I mean, you're allowed to just shoot up the place. It's illegal.
It should be. It should honestly be like, well, I didn't agree to that. I didn't sign that contract. I'm not paying you. Like, if you want me to pay that, you got to tell
me
ahead of time.
You got to put your fucking prices on the side. Like, if you get an X-ray, just put a stamp on it. Yeah. $350.
$350.
Oh, whoa.
Not
hold
covered
up.
By your insurance.
God, I had the worst. I hate dentist stories, too, and I don't want to tell one. I had a whole... Like, you can see the dollar signs in her eyes. And she's like, well, we got to hook you up to this machine, and it's going to feel your, like, jaws. I'm like, this is, like, you just seem like a scam artist. No.
Yeah.
I'm out.
It's all, yeah, it is terrifying. It's like a mechanic, but it's
never
more insidious.
Works.
Because, yeah, well, that's the only thing.
Okay.
Hey, Dick. Hey, Vito. Just wanted to call and say how amazing of a podcast this is.
Wow.
You guys have incredible chemistry.
Mm-hmm.
I love how you and Vito agree on some things, but also have very wildly different takes on other stuff.
Yeah, like shoulder nipples is a shitty problem.
No. Good on you, because I used to listen to the other biggest problem.
Mm. I don't know what that
and,
is.
And, you know, I could tell before I knew what the beef was that there was a big weird divide going on between you and Maddox, you know, towards the latter episodes. But cheers.
Sounds
yeah.
like a, some kind of a homosexual.
Never heard of this Maddox gentleman.
So Boogie, fuck, I'll listen to it next week.
No, you gotta.
I gotta find it.
Trust me, I was getting texts from Boogie about you guys' fight.
What, this week?
Yeah.
Why?
Well, because he's like, why is Dick fighting with me?
Because I'm a bully.
Well, that's what I told him.
Because you try to murder Frank Hessel. What do you mean? Because you're a liar. Because Boogie is a liar. If he cared about
but you
his...
Do you hate Boogie more than, like, most people?
No.
There you go. Yeah.
He's a liar.
Yeah.
If he cared about his mental health, he would delete Twitter and be off YouTube.
Yeah.
He's not any good at it. He can't make any money on it.
That's what I don't think I was able to communicate to Boogie is I'm like, yeah, Dick's like fucking with you, but he fucks everybody.
Yeah.
He thinks you like personally want to like destroy him. And I'm like, well, Dick personally wants to destroy
you. You're already destroyed.
Lots of people.
You don't have any money. You're a big fat retard with cancer. What am I going to do? make fun of you?
Yeah.
Everyone you know is making fun of you behind your back.
He's really having a time. I tell you what.
Oh, I hope he doesn't kill himself.
Well, we will have
No one would be sad. Like the only people
Well, Jesus Christ.
It's just a bunch of mentally ill derelicts who are in his audience telling him that him prostrating himself and getting beaten up and bullied by producing shitty content makes them feel better about their worthless lives. Like, oh, it makes me feel so good about my fat ass that you're being fat and retarded online.
I said this about the whole nature of internet content is that, yes, it's complicated.
It's real complicated to be fat and retarded. Oh, man. Hey, everybody. I'm fat and retarded.
I think that some people can't navigate the haters and the negativity.
Yeah.
And Boogie gets really down on himself when people, you know.
Oh, no.
Well, he wants everyone to love him, and I don't know how to. I want to tell him, like, listen, not everybody's going to love you, and there's a lot of reasons.
Very few people will love you.
Maybe a lot of people. He's got more people who love him probably than, you know, most people.
Probably the dentist.
He's got an audience.
Because he put his kids through college with the size of his teeth.
He did probably pay that dentist to get him out, and whoever.
botched his weight loss surgery or whatever the fuck. So,
oh, wait, it was botched?
No, it wasn't botched.
No, it wasn't botched.
It was
is that
botched
what he says?
Because he stopped eating. He couldn't stop eating, but, you know.
Oh, man.
I'm sure they did the surgery,
damn you,
right?
Doritos! Damn you!
He got the gastric bypass. It's just one of those
he
things
he should have got two.
They should have got a second one, yeah.
Yeah. They should have connected his mouth to his asshole.
I wonder if he got the skin tightening.
Why?
Well, it would have been a mistake because
stretch the skin so thin.
Oh god!
It'll be like,
oh
god! It'll be like the gold shield on an astronaut helmet.
Fuck, that's so gross.
Boogie will be the Invisible Man. You could just see all his blood pumping around and watch all the 7 Jack in the Box meals he's had today.
I think there's good in Boogie.
The good is what I have a problem with.
He was, you know, like, if you go back and you watch, like, his original Francis videos, you go, this guy's pretty funny. I get it. This is good.
I think he's very funny.
Yeah, so he's just got to pull himself out of this, like, I have cancer, like, mentality.
Why? Why a Stick Masterson and Vito?
He's one of these guys who convinces himself that bad things happen to him because he's being punished by a higher power.
He is.
Like, no,
I'm
he's
the
not.
Higher power.
No,
I'm God, Boogie.
Sure, you're God.
You should pray to me. Sacrifice your toys to me, or I'll give you 2 more types of cancer.
And I want to go, Boogie, you got a type of cancer which is apparently treatable. Okay, not you still treatable. Have an internet audience. It's not the end of the world.
He's got to get new blood.
You got to fight your way back up. He wanted to be beloved. He had a period of time where he was beloved. I missed that time. I wasn't even around for that. But apparently everybody loved Boogie at one point.
Yeah.
And then it's not the same as it was. And you got to go, hey, man, you got to fight your way back up. Do you think I should do a podcast with Boogie?
I told him that in my response video to his dumb response video.
Well, let's just say we're
exploring. Let me read his text to me.
Maybe we can talk about it on the bonus episode. Maybe this will all be bonus content, although that would take away from the theme of the episode.
Yeah,
is
you know what? I'm going to read Boogie's. I'll read Boogie's DMs on our bonus episode that you can get on patreon.com/
patreon.com/biggestproblem.
I don't want to get fucking sidetracked.
Sign up and listen to the biggest problem in 2022.
What if Boogie was like
episode.
Castle Grayskull? You know,
go that, on.
And his teeth are like the portcullis.
Okay. All right.
I'm going to make a Boogie cutout mouth like Carl.
I was thinking, I was surprised you didn't have a Boogie cutout ready for this week.
I'm surprised too, Vito.
God damn it, Carl. Get out of here, Carl.
No, no one can stop me, Carl.
Go back to where are these podcasts?
Where? All right.
All right.
No, I don't want to listen
That's
to
that a stupid one.
Okay, good.
The same guy.
Biggest problem in the universe is short form content. Oh, sorry. Hi, Dick. Hi, Vito. Short form content like YouTube Reels, TikToks, and Instagram or whatever. Yeah. Whatever. I mixed it up. Sorry. It is making us all so fucking stupid. It's making all of us autistic with how our attention spans are. And I can prove it because I've been watching shorts all fucking day at work. And it makes time go by like that, like a snap. It just, boom, you're done. Half hour. Oh, yeah, half hour to kill.
Bing, bang.
300 fucking shorts. Easy. Easy. You'll be seeing things that slightly intrigue you and also really piss you off, and somehow it just keeps you fucking going.
Yeah.
Keeps you going. Honestly, they need to go.
Do you watch any of that short form, like TikTok, Instagram Reels, any of that stuff?
Yeah, but it's only like dogs and girls with huge
tits. See, I was
going
to ask what shows up for you, because right now I get like, I get a bunch of poker videos.
What?
Yeah, and I guess I don't love poker, but I guess it's like interesting because it pays attention to like which ones you watch to the end.
Here, this one says, my mom, when I was already a C cup at 14.
So it's really just chicks showing off their boobs is in your algorithm?
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
See? Here you go. And then she's going to show her tits in a second. They always take fucking forever.
Is she going to show her tits?
Okay, let's fucking go, bitch. Get your fucking tits out.
Oh,
they're disappointing as well. See, and then there's a dog one.
Oh, little puppy.
That's all I get.
I get cat videos, poker videos, and guys reselling things they find at garage sales and thrift stores. And I go, man, my life is depressing and stupid. Although I did see a guy at a Savers find an entire bag of Muscle Man figures, and I was like, fuck, I want those. Dude, remember those, the little like plastic?
I got the biggest collection of Muscle Man figures because the guy spelled it Muxle on eBay.
Oh, shit.
I got it for like $30. It's like all the pyramid guy. Like
that's
the
awesome.
Fucking Rook guy. I still have my parents' house, I think.
That's awesome.
That was a big win for me.
Hey, I got the biggest problem in the universe. People who want resumes for trades jobs. Mm. Either you can do the job or you can't. You ask for a resume. I can go on Google and look up any stupid shit and key terms and buzzwords and blah, blah, blah. You can either do the job or you can't. Call me, or if I call you, ask me on the spot. Ask me and send me in.
Pave
for
this
interview.
Driveway.
I mean, and he's kind of got a point. I mean, show I guess it's. I mean, but it is good to have a resume. All right, I got it.
Yeah, you got it.
Yeah, I mean, they just want to know that you've done jobs before. If you say like I worked for this roofing company for 4 years, I would assume you're a better roofer than
yeah.
a guy who goes oh.
Everyone talks about how easy it is to lie, but no one lies.
Mm.
This guy, like, oh, you want a resume? I could just go online and make a resume, but you don't. Like, you know,
I mean,
you
should.
Should you yeah. could, but you don't.
Yeah,
it's like when people get busted faking resumes, it's on the news because it's so crazy that someone lied for this long and there's no penalties.
I mean, I lie on my I've lied on like every resume,
really.
Oh, thank
you. I always said I had a college degree because they never check.
You don't?
I have a 2-year degree,
but you're so brainwashed, you don't have a college degree.
I grew up in Amherst, Massachusetts.
Oh,
I got
see.
The indoctrination early.
So you basically have
I grew up in the most liberal hellhole in the country.
Okay. Thank you, everybody. Patreon.com/biggestproblem.
Real quick, show our most popular supporters, Dick, because we love
them. We got to do the
oh, the super chats.
Yeah,
you're
the
right.
Super chats.
Yes, we'll have our biggest problem. You can hear Dick's voice or DMs. Well, you didn't post Boogie's DMs to you. Did he send you more that you didn't post?
I think so, yeah. I'll read them all. Fuck Boogie.
Well, I did kind of insinuate that he should call in, but he really sounded like he didn't want to.
He never will. He would never do anything.
he's very unmotivated. I mean, I get it. If I had cancer, I would probably be like, ah, what's the point?
He was always like this.
I know.
That's how he got to be. He had fucking stomach stapling surgery. That's how worthless he is. He constantly lies to people about what he's going to do.
Point, I'm sure.
No, you're not.
Well, I might as well. What was I going to say? I don't know. I mean, yeah, it's kind of great that he has cancer because now he has the ultimate excuse. Because before it was like, why don't you get off your lazy ass and not do something? And he's like, I don't know. Now you just go. I got cancer.
He's like, well, I'm going to die anyway, so what's the point? Like, your fatness is going to kill you before your fucking cancer is.
Probably. It is a great excuse, though. Well, guys, get those super chats in. Show your support for your favorite show, the one podcast that is growing, unlike competitors. Like, who are these podcasts? Which are bleeding viewers as they... They seek out true comedy. We're gonna get that rivalry with Carl going. We love Carl.
True comedy, Vito.
We love Carl.
True comedy. True comedy is you saying you're ever gonna finish your Super Killer comic.
Oh no! I'm being roasted by Carl. My artist got COVID. I gotta wait on him.
Oh, your artist Rosie Redpalm? Is that who you're
saying? No, no, no.
All right.
Get out. Carl.
Goodbye.
Raj Gajanji for 5-somethings. Film review with Vito. Like, I just watched The Sixth Sense. I will not spoil it. Anyway, Bruce Willis is actually dead the whole time. Why do people say I spoil things? I don't think I spoil things. Jeff M for 2 says new cringe of the week material right here. Which part? What was that?
What happened? Semen?
Well, no, it was probably at the beginning of the show. What was I talking about? Oh, the Super Killer Hentai manga? Maybe that's it. Is that cringe of the week? Well,
that was good.
That was good in its own way.
I hope the uncensored one is released with
all
the rape.
I've seen the thumbnails, and there's a lot of action. John Olson
spicy.
For a big $20 on the board says, one of your biggest fans, Brad, spent Christmas in the ICU. The only laughs we had that day were listening to your last show. Like Rudolph's nose or the star over Bethlehem, you brought a little light to our Christmas day. Well, I hope Brad's okay. Wait, Brad Hedgehog? Is that who it is?
Hedgehog.
Isn't there a Brad guy?
Sonic.
Yeah, I thought there was always a Brad guy in our comments. Well, I hope you're doing well, Brad. I do think we did a great last...
If you're a good guy. If you're not a good guy, I hope that you're not doing well, actually.
If you're an Andrew Tate fan, I hope you change your life around, because...
Maybe you got put in
down.
The ICU with like a, you were beating your wife.
Yeah.
She finally had enough.
Or maybe you had a violent semen allergy. You voted up.
But maybe your wife was actually a Nazi and you were beating her for a good reason.
There you go.
We
maybe,
don't know.
We don't know why.
I don't know. But we're glad
Honor,
you're listening.
Your Honor, I did beat my wife, but in all fairness, she said the N-word. Oh, you're innocent. Case dismissed. Boom. N-word defense. That's how you get out.
But she was saying it because she was quoting me.
Oh, well, then you go to jail forever.
Ah.
No, you're not even allowed to quote it. Brett's man for two says, how much Bitcoin y'all got? I have no Bitcoin anymore.
Not enough.
Out of the game.
Not enough. Please give us more money.
ASC presents. This is from Mint Salad for 10. I am a big fan of these Hollywood special effects Dix recently brought to the show.
Yeah.
The biggest problem in the universe is how long even basic animation takes to do. Oh, currently Mint Salad is animating a segment from our Christmas show.
Oh, really?
Yeah, did you see the pictures of the elf on the shelf? Like,
no.
You haven't seen this? She posted, like, storyboards or something.
Where?
On Twitter.
Oh, I thought she was banned from Twitter.
Somebody posted. Maybe Riley posted them.
Oh, shit.
Someone is currently, either her or Riley, they're currently animating one of our segments.
Awesome.
Yeah, I'm very excited to see how it goes.
I liked her other, she animated the Joe Biden dog story. Remember that lie about when he was trying to rape his dog and he told that story?
Joe Biden never lies, Dick. Shut up. Stop it. Anyway, I look forward to that. Thanks for the $10, Mint Salad. Don't forget to find her.
On
is she banned from Fansly? Fansly.com.
No, she's not Fansly. She's banned from
slash tits mint salad. The gentleman sausage for five. Biggest problem in the universe is anonymous, unaccountable moderation teams that can engage in provably discriminatory practices without oversight. Cinder blocks for them all. You know, a problem I call that, the unbearable silence of our technological overlords voted up.
Yeah.
And social media, which was Carl's problem, which is stupid. And we hate him. Fulgor, I see your mouth.
Vito, why don't you come check out who are these socials?
I don't want to. Why don't you stick to
one? Why wouldn't you
Why don't
want
you stick to one show? You have a successful show. Are
Vito,
you spinning
if
it off?
It's for the guys that are too busy to be on Twitter.
Yeah, well, like, I'm already on Twitter. I got to go through. Why don't you just call it Carl's Twitter
account?
Why
don't you just go? You can listen to my podcast while you ride the bike.
What an old man
who
found
are these
on.
Podcasts?
An
where
old
these,
man yells at young people.
Look at this social. Right over here.
You literally, you love Simpsons. Call it Old Man Yells at Cloud, because that's your show.
Very funny, Vito. I went on TikTok, and can you believe what the young people are saying today?
Full Gore, Mark 2 for 5. Vito, after the first arc of Super Killer is over, his next arch enemy should be an African-American villain named Super Predator.
Yeah.
Says Hillary Clinton. That's pretty funny.
Well, he fights heroes, though. Or does he fight villains, too?
No, he fights heroes.
Heroes. Yeah, that's why the Sailor Moon thing is so funny.
Well, there is going to be a Sailor Moon chapter that I've been planning. There's actually promo art of Super Killer fighting a Sailor Moon.
Oh.
So maybe he saw that and was inspired.
Oh, okay.
The Treyarch Ghost for $4.99. The Idaho Killer killed thinnish women.
Death penalty.
Was that who he targeted specifically, or it just happened to go that way?
I don't know, but Buffalo Bill only killed fat women.
Therefore, he's what?
Kind of an anti-hero.
Okay. Righty tighty for two. Nine to disavow. Love the show since day one. Keep it up. Thank you, righty tighty. We'll try. Crab Zula for 10. Last episode, you guys talked about how someone needs to reclaim the swastika. Well, there was an artist from my hometown in the 60s who made that his next, his life mission. He went by the name Man-Woman. Okay, now I feel like I'm being tricked. And made paintings of happy dancing swastikas. He wrote a book called Gentle Swastika, Reclaiming the Innocence, and had 200 swastika tattoos by the time he died.
What?
Man-Woman.
Really?
Reclaiming the swastika.
Man-Woman is taking back the swastika. Vice.
Did this person die? Let's see. In the 1960s, Canadian artist and poet Man-Woman decided to reclaim the swastika. 200 tattoos and a failed marriage later, he says he's making progress. I don't think he is, and he died shortly after the interview. Fuck! This guy was going to get it done, and then he died!
And all the pictures are
And all the pictures
broken.
Are dead, because Vice is a piece of shit.
Fuck you, Vice. Look, they fucking...
They fucking deleted all the pictures.
Yeah, because they were ashamed of being associated with the swastika.
Oh my God.
They probably
give me a fucking break.
I mean, it might just be a broken article. I don't know if they did purpose. It's a 2012 article.
Access denied. Okay.
What are you trying to do? Go to archive.org or something?
No, I want to see if they deleted any
others. No thanks. Back to browsing.
That sucks. Fuck you, Vice. Well, go to all the other pictures work.
Go to the images of the Google tab. At least we can see something. Man, woman. Images. I want to see these gentle swats. Look at that happy little swastika.
It's a lot of. He looks like Sam Hyde.
Look at that. Look at that self drawing on the right there.
This one.
That. Yeah. Look at that.
How do you know it's a self drawing?
I mean, it's a guy covered in swastikas. Who else is it? It's clearly him. Look.
But self drawn, like he drew it.
Yeah, he's an artist guy. I mean, I guess somebody else might have drawn it of him.
Yeah.
You want to show the people at home real quick?
No.
All right, well, look up man, woman, swastika.
Are you crazy? I show a bunch of swastikas on this stream?
Because we're reclaiming it. We're taking it back.
I'm not reclaiming it. Man, woman is.
I have always wanted a swastika tattoo. I thought it would be like my own little private protest.
Where?
Like, put it somewhere no one could ever see it, like under an armpit or something.
Oh, God, that'll hurt. That's where no one would see it?
Or on a toe, like the bottom of your foot.
What about on the inside of your lip?
No, they might, well, I guess that you could do
like
that.
Like right there.
Just the way that it's like, you know, there was that point in time where they were calling everybody a Nazi. I think somebody else called me a Nazi, and I was like, you know what?
Yeah.
Let's dismantle this. And now I've rethought it because now everybody actually does hate Jews and the Nazis are kind of real again. And well, what are you going to do? Send your money to Ukraine, people. That's how to fight.
That's where the real Nazis are. The Azov Battalion are fighting swastikas in Ukraine.
One battalion out of many.
You support them though, right?
I don't support them specifically. It was like if somebody attacked America and then, like, the KKK formed a battalion. Are we going to say, like, oh, we shouldn't fight back against the Chinese because the KKK are one of the fighting forces?
Hold on, you're going to have to go through that slower.
China invades America. We all make little shotgun militias. And a couple of them are racist because it's America. And obviously some of the militias are going to be racist. That doesn't mean us fighting back against China is bad.
What if Israel invades America?
Let's see. Two for five. Thank you both doubly for not killing yourself. Sorry for missing last week. Glad neither of you guys have killed yourselves in my absence.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Rusty Shackleford for 10 says, Killer Stinger Vito. I think that's a great one.
Me too.
I loved it. Turkey Tom for 10 asks, are you going to the... I'm not saying it. Come on. You going
it's
to the
bad,
fair?
Tom.
Is that really
bad.
Turkey Tom? What's up, Turkey Tom?
I don't know. With anyone could 10. Be anyone. Nah, no, his channel isn't. It doesn't. It's not verified.
Well, hold
anything.
On, though. Let's see. Does it go to the real one? That's
it
the
does.
That's the real Turkey Tom,
oh,
baby.
Oh, wow.
That's Big the TT in the chat.
Wow.
I didn't know Turkey Tom was watching us. Good to see you, buddy.
He has a hot girlfriend now, doesn't
does
he?
Does he?
I think so.
I think the funniest thing with Turkey Tom was when I talked about, like, we were at, like, that rooftop party.
Yeah.
And for somehow it came up. I'm like, yeah, you know, I've had sex with, like, you know, trans girl or whatever. And Turkey Tom's eyes went wide. And he just went, you're gay! And I'm like, yeah. And it was kind of like, I think he'd never met a gay guy before or something. It was interesting. He really thought it was, like, shocking, revelatory information. And I was like, nah, it's just, like, a thing, man. Anyway, that was funny. Thank you, Turkey Tom. Hack the movies for 20 says Maddox tried to be an authority on manliness and then pretended to be a woman to get people fired. All the manly coaches are kind of weird. Do you think Maddox was a manly, kind of gave off that persona?
I think he wanted to be.
Yeah, he was kind of one of the first, like, do whatever you want, men. Women are fuck the feminists.
Yeah. But then he had so much advice for everyone on every possible thing.
Yeah.
That you could need advice on.
Like, don't call people cucks, because that's just a sexual fetish. And that was so confusing.
There's nothing inherently wrong.
There's nothing inherently wrong with being a cuck.
Tates is worse.
Oh, I did finally listen to the libertarian debate episode.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
What did you think about it?
Well, I felt bad, because, like, I obviously guys didn't think of it in the moment, but it really is that he thought small government means, like, physically small, like the number of people running it. And you're like, no, even if one guy is running the government, if that government has control
that's
over
actually the most
every
tyrannical
aspect of your yeah, that's big government. It doesn't matter how many people are running it. It's the size of the government, not the size of the people running the government. And that's what he couldn't understand. And it is infuriating in the moment to be like, no, like a few people making huge sweeping decisions for the rest of you is a small government.
Like, right, living no, right across the street from you. That's like the most government it could be.
I'm like, no, that's a huge government. That's like incredible amounts of government. That was, yeah.
And then it went on for 3 episodes, though.
I got to listen to the other episodes because I've only listened to the first one.
Got worse.
I mean, it's hard to listen to that show now, knowing eventually what happens. Yeah. Leo Lombardzardzi for Tensis Thunberg is king. I agree. I need someone to draw me Greta Thunberg as Thor. Thunberg is what I'm calling her.
She's the top G.
She's
top
the,
G Greta.
She's the goddess of lightning,
top
and,
G
in storms and climate. Marcus Aurelius, is that a furry Marcus?
Aurelius.
For two.
Marcus Aurelius. Yeah, okay.
It's a furry. For two. Says parading cars is the best sign of a grift. I agree. Colonel J for 5.
Look at my fucking Bugatti. Look at my fucking Lamborghini. Like, bro, what year do you think this is? I'm fucking Ubering. That's the height of luxury, is Ubering everywhere.
I'm also not like,
look at me, I use all my limbs to drive my car. I'm shifting over here, I'm doing pedals over here, I'm like an octopus.
But the thing about, the worst part is the thing about, like, bragging about your emissions. I'm like, that's what guys who drive, like, those stupid, like, Ford F-150s, like, yeah, this fucking, watch me roll coal and spit, like, shit in the environment. I'm like, who cares? You care that your car has bad gas, like,
there's
emissions?
There's so many funnier standards? Ways to make fun of emissions. Like, if Andrew Tate had a video that opened up on like 1,000 diesel generators just running nonstop for no reason,
yeah,
that's hilarious.
Or if he's just like, I just bought these 1,000 cows, I'm gonna make 10,000 more cows, I'm gonna destroy the fucking greenhouse.
If he had said every time Greta Thunberg tweets, I'm dumping a 10,000 gallons of oil into the ocean. That's
See, that
funny.
Is funny. Because then if he actually did, he goes, well, she tweeted.
She tweeted
10 times this month, so.
Here you go. Here's fucking 100,000 gallons.
If he just had one of those, the gas station nozzles, and he's just like, oil's just spilling into the oven.
Yeah, that's funny.
That is
but
funny.
But he's just so fucking lame.
Colonel J for 5, Dick, I'm sorry to hear about your Fediverse node. You will spin up a new one, right? And it will be Pleroma this time. Please say yes, don't give up.
Yeah, I got banned. I mean, I just found out that Medicare was quitting, and that he's so sick because I got banned from Post. Daniel Stevens or whatever, the guy.
I don't know. I'm not allowed to dox Post. Well, I'm beginning.
It's not doxing. That's his LLC.
Okay.
He defederated my instance because Ralph used his name.
Right.
Which is public. I mean, it's as public as Elon Musk. Like, he owns it.
Yeah.
He's a fucking publicly known person.
They didn't give out your fucking address or anything.
No. He defederated me, so I couldn't. I don't know what's going on with Medicare. And then Masto Host just deleted my account. So I'm like, all right, whatever. If you want to run the Pleroma instance for me, then please contact me.
This is all nonsense to me. It makes no sense. Unban my Twitter, Elon Musk. Helios for 2. Have you seen Hades 2 Eat Q-Tips Veto? I didn't play Hades 1, but I heard it was good.
Best game.
Oh, really? You played it?
Best game of the year. I played it obsessively.
It's like, is it like a, I like sauce. Is it like a dungeon crawling kind of thing? Kind of,
it's like where it's a new dungeon every time.
Yeah, yeah.
You
okay.
You get like power ups, and then like the more
so
times
is it
kind of
like
through,
Diablo?
No, because you got to do the same like the same boss guys and the same dungeon like ish things, but they change every time, and you have to like plan your power ups every time.
Interesting.
That's crazy. You got to play it.
All right, I'll play it. What was I playing the other day? I was playing something.
Yeah, I've seen Hades 2. I don't think that the girls have big enough tits in that game either.
Frozen Dick Dave for $4.99. Tate should have just put Greta to work as a cam girl job. He'd be rolling in FAS kink money right now. That seems complicated. Osama bin Diesel.
Yeah, but
too.
He has no dick. Tate, yeah. Andrew Tate has no dick.
Not anymore.
How can you look at that and think that that guy has a dick or hand or any kind
he
of...
He came off like a 15-year-old boy in that video. I was like, you to me seem more immature than Greta.
If there was a video posted
like a scared
of,
little boy.
Yeah, of him getting fucked up the ass, I would think that's
more manly.
More manly than what he posted. It's totally unrecoverable. If you don't realize that, then go cope and
see. Yeah, that's the thing. The people who are like standing by him and going, no, actually he did own her. I'm like, oh, you guys are lost.
Yeah.
You guys are lost. Everybody can see it. It's not bots. It's not the Matrix. The man.
Then she got all of her butts to come like and laugh. What she did is she was in the Matrix.
The man constructed his own L.
I was in my Bugattis. I was in my Bugattis in the airport.
You had an Andrew Tate cutout mouth, you fucking idiot. Okay. That would have been immediate. Let me do better. You don't. Are you
no,
gonna do
I
one?
Can do it. Hold on. I can do it right now. Okay. Andrew Tate. Yeah. Hold on.
Okay.
Hold on. Wait. You're going to help me pick one of these.
Jesus Christ. You got to find one where he's like facing forward.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Actually, go up. You know, you can sort by like image size.
Oh, yeah. All right.
Go to tools.
Okay.
Nope, not
sorry.
News.
Sorry. Why would I not do tools. This right now? Tools.
And then size large.
Size extra large.
That should help.
Okay.
What about that one that was in the top right? Would that work?
Where?
Top right.
That one?
Yeah.
No, it's got to be looking dead on. Doesn't it?
Kind of.
Oh, that one. Maybe.
It's just going to get you the thumbnail, I think.
Shit.
Wait, the...
This one?
I can't believe you're doing this live. Yeah, try it.
Why?
I don't
it's
know.
Funny.
Just open some of these and look at them.
Oh, here we go. Okay. Now he's got to be looking like a prick.
He's got to have his stupid sunglasses on.
Oh, yeah. Good point.
That one with the mic. Yeah, that
okay.
one.
Okay. All right. Okay.
Try that one.
That's a good one. Open image.
Yeah.
Okay.
Welcome to the Dick's Photoshop Corner. In the meantime, guys.
Talk about Super Killer.
Well, Super Killers are coming. Right now, my artist has COVID, which sucks.
Okay.
So, all the people are saying, like, hey, how come your comics, you know.
Why is it taking forever?
Well, because I would rather, I mean, first of all, even these professional guys, like a guy like Ethan Van Shiver, the thing is I don't want to do a campaign and then have, you know, you guys waiting 2 years for a comic book.
Oh, yeah.
So I'd rather do the campaign once I know everything's on track and ready to go. But even like these top pro guys, I think Ethan Van Shiver's campaign for his new Cyber Frog comic is like a year or two late. I don't want to be that guy.
A year or two late.
Yeah, I forget. And not to knock the guy. I mean, shit happens. COVID happens. He's got another book he hasn't even started on. See, that's the funny thing about
two books.
Oh, yeah. He has two different books that he kickstarted. One of them's finally about to come out. I think it's, let me see. Indiegogo. Is that where
it's about? Tell us what it's about, Vito.
Cyber Frog 2, Wrecked Planet. Okay.
Wrecked him
Planet.
Damn near killed him.
So the campaign closed on May 14th of 2020.
Okay.
And he was given $835,000.
Oh, wow.
And the comic, as far as I understand, is just going out now.
Huh.
So how long ago was May 2020? That's about 2 years, right, to make one comic?
Yeah.
I'm not knocking the guy. I'm just saying if even industry professionals...
Yeah.
Are taking that long to get a comic out. I want to make sure I don't fuck up my thing.
Okay.
And there's other stuff. There's some comics that have been taken forever. He's got another one. Why am I ripping on Ethan Van Shiver?
I don't know. Do you hate him too?
The only I beef like I have with him is he won't let me come on his live streams because his audience just has to kick me forever.
Oh.
Because, you know, it's a bunch of... He hangs out on Kiwi Farms.
Oh,
I don't know why he hangs out on Kiwi Farms. I kind of want to be like, bro, don't hang out on Kiwi Farms. There's nothing there.
Oh, so he thinks you're like a pedophile?
He doesn't... I don't think he thinks I'm a pedophile, but I think he is worried about associating with me and earning the ire of his Kiwi Farms fans.
Yeah, that's a real thing. I mean, I think that's why Null stopped associating with me, just because...
Because everybody on his stupid website was ripping on him.
Yeah, he needs money. Everybody needs money.
Hey, which is, do what you want to do. And then Ethan Manchiver raises another $360,000 for his second book. That was January 28th, 2021. So wait, if I'm to 2020, so that's 2 years.
Okay, so
that looks pretty good.
So what were you saying, Vito?
Well, I think
order me another pizza.
Okay, all right,
over here. Vito, were you talking about the Matrix?
We were talking about the Matrix. Yeah, what do you think the Matrix is trying to keep you down?
The Matrix is the reason that everything's gone wrong with your life, is why your woman doesn't respect you, your dog hates you, why your mailman comes on your packages before he delivers them.
He comes
them
on
to
my
you.
Packages? The mailman?
Your mailman hates you. He works for the Matrix. Vito, I have 10,000 supercars.
I didn't realize 10, the mailman 000. Was an essential part of the Matrix. You.
The mailmen are the center of the Matrix.
That's how they communicate to the rest of the... That's how Greta got you.
Vito, they're going to kill me. They're going to kill me.
Why are they going to kill you,
because
Andrew?
Because I'm speaking out about speaking the oligarchs of the world.
But I think you just got owned on Twitter. You think,
Vito.
Okay.
Greta said that she had a small dick. Okay.
Yeah, I know you can spin it that way, I guess.
We've all been wondering if Greta has a dick or not.
I'm not thinking about Greta's dick,
What I did
Andrew.
Was I enticed it out of her using my game that I have for, you see.
So you exposed the Matrix.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay. But then they arrested you, so it seems like this was a bad... Seems like that was not a good thing that you did.
Well, that's what, when the bad guy gets captured on purpose?
Oh, like in Avengers, like Loki.
Like in the Avengers. I don't know. I'm not familiar with that movie. I only know Matrix references. So you know when Agent Smith gets canceled and taken to Zion and turned into a human being? Let me finish. Please let me finish.
Okay.
That's what I'm doing right now. I'm in the Matrix right now being uploaded and fingerprinted.
Right. So you... okay. Well,
what?
Why did you have to traffic women, though? How does that defeat the Matrix?
Fuck women.
I'm not sure I'm following. There's a lot going on.
Do you play chess? You don't.
No,
I don't play chess. You don't seem like a chess
I'm
player.
I'm not a chessman, no.
No, you need to start playing chess. If you know in chess, when you control the queen, you control the whole board.
Yeah, but you had multiple queens, and you refused to let them leave
premises. That's
you held their passports. I don't think the queen is a hostage in the game of chess.
Me and my brother are like two kings playing
on a chessboard. You don't have two kings on chess.
Wouldn't you be?
On opposite sides.
No, because then you can't win if you only if
the
you have two
the king's the weakest
kings.
Piece in chess. You don't want two
That's
kings.
What the Matrix wants you to think,
Okay,
Vito.
Well, this is all convoluted, Andrew.
No, see, what I have a whole...
A room full of women you've enslaved.
I have a whole stable of queens. And me and my brother are two kings playing on the same board. And we also have 33 supercars, and we smoke cigars that are not penises all day.
Okay, well, I'm glad that you're not smoking penises.
Have you ever kickboxed, Vito?
No, I have never kickboxed, Andrew.
You don't know.
I don't see how that's important, though. Did that enlighten you to the Matrix?
It's only the most important. Have you not seen the Matrix? It's all kickboxing and flying
is
around.
Is that why you became you saw the Matrix and then you decided you were going to fight your way out? So you learned kickboxing?
Have you been subscribing to my course for this?
No, I haven't subscribed. I don't understand.
You're giving this
what
stuff
are you
away.
Telling
you're giving
these
away
men?
My secrets for $6,000. Number one, you're in the Matrix. Number two, you need to be kickboxing to get on the Matrix. Number one, number
this
three.
Does not seem like a viable strategy for most men.
That's, well.
You may also be right. Neo only had one woman. He didn't. Neo never kidnapped women in the Matrix. He just had Trinity.
It's not kidnapping.
Well, you're not letting them leave.
They could leave at any time. I just have their passports, I keep their phones, and I have access to all the emails, but they could leave at any time.
Did Neo give Trinity 60, take 60% of Trinity's OnlyFans earnings? Andrew, I just think that what you're doing...
The money's not real, Vito. That's what you need to realize. The money is 60% of pretend... See, the Matrix...
Yeah.
The Matrix is all around us. It's in the money
you earn. I just don't really...
Your woman doesn't respect you, Vito. How does that make you feel?
It feels fine because I don't want to take her passport away. That seems...
What's wrong with that?
You think they
I'm just storing it for safekeeping. Vito, can you get me a pizza, please?
No. Are you going to recycle it afterwards?
Vito, don't recycle nothing. I don't recycle
anything.
What's
wrong with recycling?
I don't even poop in the toilet. I put the poop in a Ziploc bag and bury it in the yard so it will take 10,000 years for the poop
to return
to the ecosystem.
Andrew, I don't think polluting is that cool. I don't know why you're bragging about your emissions from your cars. And I just think you're going overboard.
You sound like a 19-year-old girl, honestly.
I think I might. I think I identify more with Greta than
I'm actually
going
to have to own you on Twitter.
Well,
I'm going to make a 10
are you gonna make a video?
Video series from prison about how much of a loser you are. I couldn't even, if I had to live a day in your life, I'd kill myself.
Oh, I'm sure. Well, Andrew, I look forward.
I would drive a supercar so fast that I would die from it. I would drive it so fast that I would die.
But if you're in the Matrix, I mean, that speed isn't even real, right? And that supercar, why are you so proud of a car if it's all an illusion? It's just code. Didn't the system give you that car? Seems like you've been just trapped yourself in a web of the Matrix itself has taken you, and all of this persona you've created around yourself is as much of an illusion as the illusion you preach that men need to escape from. You've built yourself a prison in Romania to the point where you set yourself up in a room where the authorities are immediately able to apprehend you and force you to submit to their whims. Wouldn't a true Matrix man have escaped into a paradise of his own creation? It seems like this is all an elaborate farce meant to scam young men of their money for your ridiculous masculinity courses.
Vito, I could kick your head off. Right?
Well,
right now, I mean, okay?
Yeah, sure.
Okay? Vito, do you even play chess?
No, I don't play chess, Andrew.
Do you even know how many pieces there are in chess? I'm going to be playing a lot of chess 48? In prison. Actually, have you ever even seen The Shawshank Redemption?
I have I've seen that.
I love that movie.
Yeah. That's about escaping a prison as well. It's
the
a
Matrix.
The Matrix.
The Matrix. Everything is a Matrix.
All right. So
your hat is a Matrix.
All right. This everything's the Matrix,
show
Andrew.
Is a Matrix.
Thank you, Andrew
Super
Tate.
Chats
Thank
are a Matrix.
You for telling us
Goodbye.
All about the Matrix. All right. Thank you, Andrew Tate.
I have successfully stolen Conan O'Brien's greatest bit.
Yes, you have.
Okay.
And you've made it your. I don't know what
I
you're talking
you
about.
It would
that
be
was
worth
the real
it.
Andrew Tate. What bit? Andrew called in. Let's finish these fucking super chats.
Okay.
Good old Andrew Tate. No, I'm just fucking with you. Mullet Kid says, I need more Conan clutch cargo bits. Well, there you go.
Oh, wait. No, that was
Yeah, scroll
skip.
Down a little
okay,
bit.
Okay, sorry. Let me refresh.
We got a lot of super chats today,
you guys
folks.
Wait too long to do your super chats.
Hey, everybody's got to get them
should
in.
Should do it at the beginning.
No, get it? Well, they people want to respond to the show. Oh, God, there's so many.
Jesus.
Oh, my God. All right, we're going to rip through these. All right,
Hades 2.
All right.
Yeah, you got to play Hades.
I'll play it. I'll play it.
All right.
All right, click off so I can see. Osama bin Diesel for 2. Is Dick going DEFCON 3 on Andrew Tate? I think you just got your answer.
Yeah.
Well hung and dung for 2. Andrew Tate isn't a misogynist. He's a proud Muslim. Inshallah. David March for 5. Does Andrew Tate know that jokes are supposed to be funny? We like jokes. Alex for 10 says, it's fair to be too far, but it's fair to be too far to be sure. Fairly sure to be too far, but to be sure, it's fairly beefy too. Too fair, the far B says, but the fair B too has two B hairs.
Ah, oh, damn
none.
It.
There's none in
damn
there.
It.
And I did the whole thing. That was beautiful,
wow,
Alex.
Wow, good job, Alex.
Alec Awesomer thanks. For 5. What happened to the bonus episodes on the Patreon feed? What do you mean? I don't know.
They're still there.
Yeah, go find them.
Contact Patreon support.
James Gardner for $9.99 says Super Killer should have a reluctant sidekick named The Bad Man.
Oh, yeah, that's cool.
It is cool. My buddy made that shirt. Inshallah for 5 from Leo Lombazardi. Koof for 2. Use an Onahole, Vito. Jesus, I thought you were a weeb. What, and then all my cum goes in like a little anime lady's plastic pocket pussy? I don't want to deal with that.
Yeah, Onaholes are a pain in the ass to clean out because you like put hot water in it and the cum kind of bubbles out. You're like, it's not really like clean.
Yeah, it's gross.
You got to turn it inside out.
Is that where we are? Are we?
No.
No. You keep moving around.
No, I didn't do that. I just resized the window.
Oh, all right. Go past Koof. Proctors for 2. Siemens in the Bible. Look up Onan. Is that true? Is that what Siemens named after?
I don't even know what that means.
Onan. Well, isn't
Odin?
Well, it's an own a hole is the thing we were just talking about. O-A-N-O-N-A. And
it's from Japan.
Yeah. And what does Japan call it when you like put stuff up your dick? I don't remember. Anyway. Carrie for 5 says this is a weird episode. All our episodes are weird. Thinking Cat for 2, Dick, buy a mannequin and put the sweaters on it. Put it on your fucked up fucking sex doll, which is trending now.
Put all my sweaters on.
Did you
on
see that?
That
people were taking the picture I took of your sex doll and like posting it elsewhere?
Like, yeah, I don't go into your house and take pictures of your stuff and put them online.
You can. If you had it's her fucked up knees. It's giving everyone tryptophobia because she has all these holes in her knees.
Whatever.
It's fucking disgusting. Get her some knee pads. Michael winning for 5, the Mile High Club, a.k.a. Snakes on a Plane, correct? Little snakes swimming around in your balls. Who are these podcasts is here?
Yes!
With a fucking $2 donation. Carl, come on.
Super chats are for N-words.
Super chats are for N-words.
That's rough.
Carl!
Buddy, that's rough.
You're gonna get canceled for that sort of thing. Slash Bold for 5, time to stump Dick. Dick, I never cared for Tate, but how come you didn't speak out about him prior to his arrest beyond mentioning he stole your bit?
Well, I thought he was funny.
Yeah, and then he did an embarrassing thing.
I thought he was funny, and then he called. Look, he was on the show. He was funny on the show. He talked about women. I mean, I think the pimping stuff is cool. Whatever, I don't care.
He did a terrible bit.
And he did a really, really bad bit, and then he doubled down on the bit.
He doubled down on a bad bit.
And then you look
worse
at all the guys who are supporting him, and you're like, this is psychotic. This is bad. These guys are paying this money to, like, have friends, and that's bad. I don't like that. Yeah. Like, I don't charge that much for this show. $20.
Well, I was
$60
I was
for
say,
the
Dick,
live show.
You always, I mean, people compare you to, like, you know, Andrew Tate. The thing is, you never turned it into a weird grift.
It's
like,
funny.
Like, you made a book, like, that's technically, like, I don't know, a advice book or whatever, but it's a joke.
My advice is, like, do drugs.
Do drugs and have fun and make comedy. And
don't do them too much. And
sure.
People are like, what about investments? Like, I don't know, buy the index funds. Like, you can't do better than that.
Yeah, pretty much.
Buy Bitcoin. Not too much, though.
Not too much.
Like, I'm not like, listen to me and your wildest dreams will come true. They won't. Give up your dreams. They're dumb.
And there's,
life sucks.
And there's no room in this world for a common sense, like, have fun and don't kill yourself kind of. It's either I'm going to solve your whole life, you're going to clean your room every fucking day and live like a god for it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Ride Dog for 5. Please give us an MP3 of the Vito's Twitter song. I get it randomly stuck in my head all the time. Okay. This is the song you get stuck in your head?
Vito's
yeah,
Twitter.
It's great.
Vito's Twitter.
Because the
Vito
words are
Vito
placed
Twitter
perfectly.
Vito's Twitter.
Because they're slightly behind the beat, like a drum,
Twitter.
Like a good drummer.
Vito being Vito on
except
Twitter
for that one.
Where did you?
You're fucking touching my
Vito
feet.
Playing footsies. Where did you find
Vito
this song?
On Twitter.
I made it.
Did you?
Yeah.
Congrats. You're an excellent musician. Gun Ranger for 10 Says, I like chauvinists who don't get arrested.
Yeah, me too. Same. Me too, buddy.
Mike Hunt for 10. The biggest problem are people who go after Dick and New Project 2 saying it was a con and a grift. Like somehow destroying Dick or Ralph will allow them to absorb their fame. Everybody does this. Anytime anybody suffers any sort of setback, it's like, well, I never liked them to begin with, and this is a personal win for me. Like, fuck those people. Mullet Kid for 5. I need more Conan Clutch Cargo bits. I agree. Mike Hunt for 5. Boogie lied about Fight Ralph and about fighting Sam. I doubt he even had cancer or got jerked off by his dad.
I do. I doubt that, too.
You don't think he got jerked off by his dad?
Or that he has cancer.
I think he has cancer.
I think he jerked off his dad, and he feels bad about it. So now he's saying that his dad jerked him off. Yeah.
Yeah. His dad got snakes all over.
He probably, Boogie probably snuck into his dad's room while he was sleeping, started jacking him off. Okay. And then his dad woke up, and he's like, get out of here, you fat retard. And now Boogie retells it.
It's pretty bad.
You know? Because he lied about Frank Hassel in the same way.
I'm not going down this.
Well,
this
is true.
Lemon Sake for 5. Carl from WATP probably has fan art of himself as a South Park or Simpsons character on his wall. I bet he does. Carl, do you have...
No, I can tell you for sure.
What, from his background? You got the background?
Yeah.
Does he have a little, ooh, what if I was, what if I was Pickle Rick?
There it is.
It's me, Pickle Carl. I'm Pickle Carl. Is that South Park stuff behind him? Oh, my God. The 90s, huh? Drunken Atheist Studio for 2. Remember Battle Beasts? Those were cool as fuck. I don't remember Battle Beasts.
Me either.
Mike Hunt for 5. I want to see Dick's BoJack Horseman whiskey ending rant animated. Is that from the one when we did, like, the podcast about it?
With Ralph?
Yeah. And you guys were like, no, this is great. He hasn't learned anything, and he refuses to change. And I'm like, I don't think that's the ending, necessarily.
Yeah, it should be.
There's a little of that.
That's the ending. Lemon
Sake, thoughts on the at Vito Jizwa? Yeah, there's a fake me account out there on Twitter.
It's too close. I appreciate that someone is.
It would be better if
funny,
it was like,
but it's too much. Like, it's too much being the actual Vito.
Sometimes
so
it's just shit
it.
I would actually say.
Yeah. So,
but like said in like a really blunt, stupid way.
Yeah. There's not enough super crazy stuff. Go harder. I would say.
Just stop. Also, I just hate though that it like it. Can you put like parody in the name?
People think it's you.
People think it's me. And I'm like, all right, well, that's annoying.
Yeah,
I get that's part of the joke, but like, whatever. Matt White for 10. Maddox lost.
Mm-hmm.
That's correct. Claptrap and Destroyer for 5. This is a cool shirt, Vito. Check it out at skeletontrashbag.com. My buddy makes cool shirts, including his new line of Christopher Dorner inspired merchandise.
Oh.
Yeah, I got to get his.
Can't corner the Dorner.
I got to get his Can't Corner the Dorner shirt.
That's cool.
Skeleton Trash Bag. I should bring him on sometime, but he lives in NorCal right now. G-Man for 5. I'm all for limiting the size / weight of people running the government.
Yeah.
A lot of fatties.
The government should never be more than 500 pounds.
Justice Done for 5. The show is performing an abortion on the Super Killer IP. That's kind of happening. Claptrap for 5 says, this Tate bit is incredible. All right, give us one more refresh.
All right.
We can get our last couple super chats in, but guys, what a great show. We've been visited by so many fantastic guests. We had Carl from WATP came by. We had Andrew Tate himself.
Oh, shit. Did I not resize it correctly?
I don't know. No, because you put it in a different window.
I did?
Yeah, didn't you have it in a...
Oh, yeah, the...
There we go. There's Andrew Tate is here.
Vito.
Yeah. Hi, thanks for coming by, Andrew.
Do you have any last words for The Matrix?
Well, it's been a lot of fun, and I don't know what's going to happen on the other side.
There is no other side. It's just Matrix, Matrix, Matrix.
Okay, it's just The Matrix. Thank you, Andrew.
Let me put up the
put
guys.
Up our supporters. We love you guys. Don't forget, bonus episode, The Biggest Problem in 2022.
Whoops.
You're going to get that exclusively at patreon.com/biggestproblem. So be sure to sign up for that. We're going to have some exclusive content on that bonus episode, and you're not going to want to miss it. And thanks to all our supporters for keeping the show going. It continues to grow. The big challenge for 2023.
10 grand!
Get us to
if
10 grand.
If we get 10 grand, Vito will show his dick on the show.
I did not say that.
Vito will lose 50 pounds and bicycle a marathon.
I'll lose 50 pounds.
Miles.
I'm not showing my dick on
Vito
mine.
Will show his dick.
No, I'm not
if
showing my dick.
If you get us
dick.
To $10,000.
I'm not doing that. But why don't you tell 2 friends about the show? go into one of your group chats, go
take
to work.
Take their passports.
Take their passports and force them to listen. Tell two friends. That's your challenge for the month of January. I want you to DM your friend right now. Go on Facebook, go on wherever, Instagram, and go, hey, if you ever want a great podcast to listen to, check out The Biggest Problem in the Universe.
Harass journalists.
That's also a good idea.
Say you have to say Andrew
say
Tate
you're
did an
bomb
exclusive
their building
episode
if they don't listen to.
On the exclusive interview on the show, you dumb bitch.
Tell them you got to listen to what Andrew Tate's saying on Biggest Problem. He went wild.
He fucked a pizza.
He admitted to all the trafficking, and he fucked a pizza, and he broke the Matrix. Guys, what a show! Take care of yourself, and God bless America. God bless Ukraine.
Oh, fuck you.